All right, it's Player Talk Radio. We are in the building. It's DJ Kuda back at the helm of today's show. Let's start tonight's show.
Get now in the mix with the young DJ Kuda.
Tonight we gonna be going in.
All the ones and twos and twos.
Let's get it.
On Player Talk Radio.
We in the building, it's Player Talk Radio. Let's start tonight's show. Let me get these levels right. Hold on. All right, let's get it. If you got any questions, you can email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That's playertalk8@gmail.com, man. We are in the building. It's Player Talk Radio. We're going to have a special show tonight. On tonight's show, we're going to be talking about the Black MGTOW. And is there a war on masculinity in the black community? We're going to talk about that shit on tonight's show, man. It's Player Talk Radio. You know, only pause like that because I thought I was gonna fuck up the title of the show, but I got the title right. So look, let's start tonight's show, man. Shout outs to DC, man. Let's get it, man. We're gonna do tonight's show for DC, man. I'm gonna have a good go-go mix. Without further ado, let's get it started, man. It's Player Talk Radio. We are in the building, man. We're gonna talk about that bullshit on tonight's show. So let's get it, man. Let's go.
Now you know you gotta break the game down a little bit more because they might be slow.
It's Player Talk Radio. We in the building. Shout outs to Wale, let's get it, man. Pretty Girls, let's start the go-go mix, man. Girls, this one for DC, man, let's get it, man. I'ma do it for the home. Let's get it.
Remind you of the sky when I'm in it. We on cloud nine for that minute. Am I your style and your physique? And I ain't trying to critique, but you deserve a good drink. What's up? What you sipping on? It's no problem. Black and gold bottles like I'm pro New Orleans. But shawty, I'm far from a saint, but I got two AMXs that look the same way. Wale, DC, that's me, huh? My pride to say Prada and they pride to say Fila. I ain't gotta tell you, they know about me, huh? You come to DC and I can make you a believer. So baby, I'm a leader, stay away from a Libra. And I ain't trying to leave you wrong, Chicanesia. So would you please listen to what I'ma need from you? Live for tonight before tomorrow's amnesia.
Yeah, they call me Gucci, but I'ma buy you Louis. Yellow stones on my wrist remind me of a slasher. Girl so fine, wanna ride me like a heavy. Ugly girls quiet, pretty girls ride. Ugly girls see me, girls go the wrong time. Got her in the bed with a two-way body. Took her to the club, bought her three more pies. Keep her rolled on, let her let her out of her. Black diamond bigger than a black razor. Asian, black color change and a blazer. Persuasion, so amazing, it's amazing. How they stand there, cause they're patient. Waiting to the perfect time for conversation. My observation, tell me that she's Gucci baby. Baby,
I said do this more.
roll with it, roll with it. Yeah. I don't know what y'all gonna do. Y'all gonna be front tonight, or y'all gonna get on in. You know what I'm saying? Up and up in here tonight, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, hey, true.
Just been cracked in the head with another DJ. You just been cracked in the head with another. Damn, son. Yeah. You just been cracked in the head with another DJ Young Cuda exclusive.
Shoutouts to UCB and shoutouts to Rare Essence, man. Y'all know about this shit. Shoutouts to Rare Essence, man. RE, what's good, bro? What's good with all of y'all, man? Let's get it, man. Backyard, man. Let's get it.
Say what? We got the one. We got the one.
Long live Go-Go, man. Let's get it, man. Shout out to the backyard. All right, it's Player Talk Radio, man. We are in the building, man. I'm sorry. I was in the background cranking. I'm nigga, I done went down memory lane like shit listening to that shit. I almost had a seizure. God damn. Nigga, I had to light some candles and shit. Woo. Y'all don't understand. Son, the go-go scene in D.C., man, it was lit. It still exists. It's just not the same. It's just not the same. You know what I'm saying? You know, dog. Do you know how much good go-go remixes, if like niggas in the city is on it? But like niggas in the city, there's like a bit of hungriness that was like around this time. Niggas was hungry. Like niggas was on it. Like go-go was the shit. Go-go's still the shit. It's just you gotta, you know certain spots to go and find it and shit. But this was the music that moved the city. You understand what I'm saying? Like songs would come out and like niggas didn't even like the regular song. They like, nah, the go-go version crank harder. And then you go listen to the go-go version, that shit crank like a motherfucker. Then you don't even like the song no more. Niggas nowadays ain't hungry. There's some songs out here they could have had, that Ben had the go-go version, and that shit would crank. But this backyard, man. Shout out to the folks, man. My bad. This shit just done put me down memory lane, man. Y'all niggas know what I know what I'm talking about, man. The cats nowadays ain't that hungry, bro. These niggas, man. Real niggas in the city, dog. You know when back in the day you going home from La Pearl. One night your ass was at H2O. Nigga, you was at Club Dream back in the day. Stumbling out the club and this all you heard, son. This all you heard, son. This. You blasted in the car? This shit right here? Come on, man. Let me tell you something, man. It's something about bongos and drums and shit. Nigga, it don't matter who you are, son. Your hip's about to move, son. The type of spirit these niggas was playing around with back in the day, son. Nigga, you have to travel to the depths of Africa to find that type of shit. DC was Afrocentric. DC's still Afrocentric. I'm just saying, you gotta know where to find the shit now. But there's a spirit in DC that's still alive, man. So, you know, capital of the world, man. I had to do tonight's show. I had to dedicate the mix to DC, bro. Some politics going on, that's all. Alright, man. This is my shit right here. Hold up. Nigga said he cranking. Hold up. Shout out to my boy. Hold up. Bro, I tell you nothing. I tell you the whole truth and nothing but the truth. Hold on. Hold up. nothing but the whole truth. Hold up. I put some AAO in this bitch. Hold up. Shouts to Guap, man. Throwing this rock meat real quick. Hold on. We started tonight's show. It's Player Talk Radio. We in the building. Hold up. One more for the purists. Hold up. Start tonight's show, man. It's Player Talk Radio.
Now you know you gotta break the game down a little bit more because they might be slow.
I am in the building. This Player Talk Radio. DJ Kuda back at the helm of today's show. I'm gonna get to a clip. We're gonna talk about the black MGTOW. We're gonna talk a little bit about MGTOW. And I want to kind of dedicate this show to, you know, the brothers that are in search of MGTOW. Brothers specifically a little bit, you know. A lot of you guys know what it is. A lot of you guys don't know what it is. There's a lot of, you know, talk and speculation around MGTOW. I'm not a MGTOW. Or maybe I am one. I don't fucking know. I don't consider myself one. But I understand the role that MGTOWs playing the game. And email me at playertalk8@gmail.com. That's playertalk8@gmail.com. If you want to donate to the show, you can donate via PayPal at CUDAKID8@yahoo.com. That's CUDAKID8@yahoo.com. But like getting back to what I was talking about with the black MGTOWs, You guys gotta stop listening to people that are, you know, uneducated on, you know, a lot of the aspects and the subjects, you know. I'm still trying to learn the shit. You dig what I'm saying? I grew up with this shit, so I understand what it is. But they're gonna bring up these stupid ass talking points. And I'm gonna, I actually have a clip for you guys tonight on those stupid ass talking points that they're gonna bring up. It's gonna be the same shame and tactics and shit. So hold on. Going into this. Hold on. I got a lot of shit going on in the background. Hold on. My fucking immediate attention is divided. Hold on. Give me 1 second. 1 second, y'all. Yeah, so on tonight's show, I want to talk to the brothers a little bit about Black MGTOW. You know what I'm saying? And actually, the conversation that I'm going to have with you guys on tonight's show is actually not new. Like, you know, a lot of IBMORs, one of the IBMORs that you may know is BGS, but IBMOR is introspective. Fuck. Hold on. I don't want to get it wrong. My bad, y'all. And I don't know why I'm lapsing on acronyms on tonight's show, because I'm thinking of, I got MGTOW in mind. Hold on. Hold on. But Idmore's introspective black male of reform. You know what I'm saying? Introspective. I'm lapsing on Idmore. Give me a minute. I'm gonna look that shit up. I got a whole bunch of tabs pulled up that I need to X out. Hold on, y'all. And then you got Idmore, you got SYSBM. This conversation I'm gonna have with you brothers on tonight's show. Hold on, let me pull this shit up. I'm trying. Hey, if you know how to work Streamlabs, can you email me? Because I need to learn how to work Streamlabs. And OBS. So the conversation that we're gonna have tonight is a conversation that actually happens in Idmore and SYSBM. Circles, which, you know, are, you know, black men, you know, that, you know, get together as a collective, and they hold like the educated, intelligent class of black males that quote unquote feels that they've been overlooked or burned by the system, or, you know, a lot of different things going on. There's a lot of they're a class full of brothers, full of men. Okay. Now, and a lot of those brothers feed into MGTOW because, if you don't know, black men have invented MGTOW. Black men had invented MGTOW. And then, you know what I'm saying, they were just sharing internet. They were just sharing all the shit on the internet, just like this on YouTube, you know. The black man that invented MGTOW, his name is Barbarossa. And Barbarossa, he created MGTOW and then started... You know, there was other black channels, but, you know, there were just black people on YouTube doing their own thing. And that created a game. And then that created, it brought the game to the internet and all kinds of shit start popping off. But then you have this specific special group of brothers, which are MGTOWs, that are men that have, you know, their own, you know, thoughts about things. They're not going to conform to society, or, you know what I'm saying? Some of them, they, you know, they just want to chase their dreams. Some of them, you know, MGTOW, which is men going their own way, stands for men getting tired of women. Sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It could mean anything. You know what I'm saying? It's these group of dudes that just go their own way, and they live their life the way that they want to live it. And some of them are incels, which are niggas that are, you know, voluntarily celibate. You know what I'm saying? And yo, Sandman said some crazy shit on the other show. He said femcels. I never heard of femcels, but hey, look, I wouldn't put it past them. There's a class of women out here that are saving themselves for whatever reason. You know, some of them are reborn again hoes. You know what I'm saying? So, as above, so below. If it's happening in one society, it'll be happening in the next. But one thing that he said what was interesting is that the femcels kind of boss around the incels online, which I don't know. That's what's going on in white society. I look at what's going on in white society, and then I kind of compare it to what's going on in black society, because then I can see what niggas are really trying to do. And they already have movements out here for black men that doesn't include MGTOW. So it's a lot of shit going on. Honestly, this sounds like a whole big rant. This sounds like a whole big rant of nothing. But if you're like hip to what I'm talking about, you will understand exactly what I'm talking about. So, you know what I'm saying? All of these dudes come together and they go their own way. Now, what a lot of women and guys don't realize is that when they hear about this group, they perceive it to be a movement. And the only movement that they can relate it back to is, you know what I'm saying, the feminist movement, because that's the last movement that they think of. It's not the LGBTQ, but then they kind of throw that in there too, because they have this whole thing where it's like men going their own way where they want to go. Personally, I'm not going to go nowhere where women aren't, because I'm not gay. You know, that stupid shit. Are these guys gay? Oh my God. They throw out all of this stupid shit which is the same shaming tactics and shaming language these niggas already done had talks about and dismantled. Anything that these niggas, whether you a player, a pimp, Mac, whatever you want to call yourself, these MGTOW niggas had talks about all of that shit. I saw all of that shit. Them niggas talked about all of that shit. Like, it's to the point that whenever you try to form your own idea of what you're going to say to them, it's already a that's last week's conversation. And they're a couple steps ahead of you in that shit. And that's because MGTOW is not just one set group of niggas. They are, you know what I'm saying, niggas in high places, niggas in low places. They're just niggas that all come together and talk about financing and working on their business and things like that and talk about everything. And they do kind of nitpick at women. But you have to understand, these are scorned motherfuckers for whatever reason, whether you got put on child support, nigga, and stuff like that. These are scorned niggas coming together, chopping up game. Game get talked about in this circles. This ain't just pain. Like, motherfuckers think, well, you sit together, oh, y'all just hurt. Y'all just butt hurt and all this other shit. You go on the internet and talk shit? No, it's not going on the internet and talk shit. Them niggas are actually talking about some real fucking shit. You know what I'm saying? That's why when that whole Cynthia G shit popped off, that shit was hilarious. Black YouTube was on that shit. You know what I'm saying? Black YouTube lit up. These people ain't out here just, you know what I'm saying, talking about bullshit. But anyway, don't let me sit up here and rant and take you away from where I want this show to go, where, you know, it's intended. But I wanted to talk about Black MGTOW because Black men invented MGTOW. Yeah, white man got his thing with it and he runs with it and fuck it. We get together and chop up game. For real, for real. When I'm in the MGTOW circles, I don't even look at color. I'm like, yo, he said some funny shit. Or sometimes, you know, some of these white dudes, because there's some crazy ass, most of them niggas for real that's on the internet, I don't even tell you the truth, they're not even MGTOW. So I have them niggas with the MGTOW shit in their name, they're really not MGTOW. And another thing also is that when, because, you know, you got racist websites like Stormfront and all these Reddit and shit. They be, you know, some racist shit everywhere. This is the internet, which is the world. So it's some racist shit anywhere. It don't take you that long to go find some racist shit. You understand what I'm saying? So all I'm saying is that, you know what I'm saying, when they do say some of the racist shit, even in their own language, like, towards each other, because, like, you know, it's like a slang. Like, if you understand white humor, it's like a dry type humor. And sometimes that shit actually be funny. Sometimes the motherfucker just joking, you know what I'm saying? People nowadays take things a little bit too seriously. You know what I'm saying? Like, this show, like, motherfuckers listen, oh my God, they take it seriously. You know what I'm saying? We live in the most triggered yet... this society is just this hyper triggered, like these niggas be lighting the fuck up at the sight of some news. It's like, hold on, let the person, you know, tell the story out. Shit. Yeah, these niggas be anytime something little, they just get triggered over it, man. Oh, don't let me rant. Okay, so. Yeah, all of that shit is old conversation, man. And the fact that people just they have these outdated fucking shaming tactics and shit. It just further proves their point, man. I be looking at that shit. Alright, let me see. I said I was gonna do something. And I don't think I'm holding up to what I said I was gonna do. But how I wanted to equate back to the whole fucking... the whole black community. Because I want the black community to actually acknowledge their MGTOWs. Because the white community is gonna acknowledge their MGTOWs. The black community... community, they're going to be slowed down by shaming tactics and shit like that. See, one thing black people, like, never understand. Black people never understand shit that they themselves made. Like, it's till you do your research, you found out niggas made peanut butter and shit. You know what I'm saying? It's till you do your research that you see, damn, you know, the black man invented a whole bunch of shit. Shit, hell, even the black woman invented hella shit that got repatented and sold like they didn't even have nothing to do with it. You know, that's like the quintessential story. That's like black people's plight. Just re-understanding ourselves. Ain't that fucked up? That type of information alone would slow your ass down. It's like, damn, now I gotta relearn some shit. Damn it, now I gotta unlearn some shit. And then relearn some shit right after I unlearn some shit. That's discipline. Niggas just sitting up here to just be slowed down by repeating something. Motherfuckers can run 10 miles. You gotta sit up there and run 20. Then when you get to the finish line, oh, you got nice legs. Hey, man. And you're like, yo, man, I'm about to take a knee. Nah, don't do that, bro. They're going to cut your contract. You can't even take a knee. All right, man, let's start tonight's show, man. It's Player Talk Radio. We got enough people in the room. We was cranking earlier. Where were y'all at? All right, let's get into it, man. Let's go.
Sister, you know what I can't stand? Who wants to back up one? I hate when I run into a rich nigga and he comes at me with this whole,
the fuck did that bitch just say?
You know, I want someone who could get to know me for me. I want to spend time. Bitch, I don't want to spend time. I want to spend your money.
Uh-oh.
Don't ask me to spend time. Ask me to spend your money. Say, pour some vini. Your lajan. What you think? You think I'm here to get to know you, bitch? I'm not here to get to know you. I'm here to get to know your bank account. What's your account balance? I need to access to your account. Bitch, I see how you be popping bottles. Come pop these bills over here. A bitch ain't got no time. I need money. I don't have time to spend. I need money to spend. Bitch, don't come at me because you think I'm a good girl. And I don't want to get to know you. I'm trying to get to know your money, period. Don't come at me with that.
Damn. She said, don't come at me with that bullshit.
I see how you be popping bags, popping bottles on these other hoes. Come pop these bills, period.
See how they can just turn that shit off and on? Rather be with you and all your bullshit, huh? Alright. So, look. On the last show, we were talking about black female YouTube. And we were discussing Michi X going at Paris Milan. There's another black YouTuber named Sarah Lena. I watch her stuff. I don't know how to pronounce the name. I always fuck it up. I always fuck up names. I know the name and then I still fuck it up. Ain't that a bit? Hold on. Lately, she's been doing more podcasts with her husband, who looks like a weird version of Too Short and some, I don't know. Anyway, these are this is a black couple talking about MGTOW. Check this out. If you're in the MGTOW, you'll get some laughs out of this. This shit is going to be funny. Okay. Now, if you're in the MGTOW, you know when somebody, just on the type of grievances they have, you know when somebody's been around the information or haven't been around the information. Because it's not a movement, It's an ideology. You understand what I'm saying? Once you fully gone your own way or walking your path, you will embrace MGTOW because you yourself will have certain ideologies that you stick by. And then you listen to the Red Pill content. You're like, damn, this the same shit I be talking about. Damn, okay. Oh, that's a great way to look at that. Oh, damn, that's, you know what I'm saying? It's game. You got to soak it up. And these things are truths. And these truths are answers to problems. And these answers to problems, you know, in the game, we call it information. And when game is being conveyed, we're playing around with certain types of information. And sometimes if somebody laces you with game, he laces you with different variations of that information to solve the problem. You understand what I'm saying? Some women, you know what's funny? Dudes, we've had a show where we talked about dudes are one task minded. Like, we see problem, we solve it. Done. You know what I'm saying? With women, sometimes they don't want the problem solved immediately, or they haven't really fully thought it out. You understand what I'm saying? And then when you solve it, they're like confused or whatever. A lot of times, too, fellas, game is the way you go about solving the problem. And sometimes you can switch up your game to the type of girl to, because some girls will, you know, be impressed by how you solve the problem. But you just have to show her the steps in a different way about how you go about doing it. And then the steps that you take to go about solving that problem, she looks at you, oh my God, the character. You know, they do shit like that. You understand what I'm saying? So all I'm saying is that, you know what I'm saying? That's what game is. It's information. So these MGTOWs, what y'all got to understand is that they're passing around information. And things like shaming tactics and 10 steps, you know, the broad will use. And you know, like all kinds of dumb shit gets passed around. So when you hear a couple that hasn't even done their full research on what they're talking about, and then just go far left with it. They're like just off the marker. This shit is some hilarious ass shit because it's like, no, that's not it. That's not it, champ. That's really not it. So let's hear this clip. Let me stop ranting. I'm just excited to talk about this shit. It's just, I don't know. All right, listen to this. This is hilarious. Check this out. Sarah Lena and her husband talks about Black MGTOW.
Peace, families, as you can see.
Now, one thing, too, Black people are under the impression that they didn't create MGTOW. When Black men created MGTOW, MGTOW is actually a response to feminism in a way. In a way, it is a direct response to feminism. You understand what I'm saying? Because the cutoff. So I don't think it was meant to be a direct response to it, but thank God it is. So that's how niggas are looking at it. But where feminism usually terrorizes is in a matriarch. And white people still live in a patriarch. To indulge in a matriarch is a perk from living in a patriarch. You understand what I'm saying? Sway male's perspective or opinion. And also take advantage of male caring nature. So when you have white men experiencing feminism from a patriarch standpoint, he's going to do more mentally. You know, he'll realize before you that he's being, like, he's not going to take that shit. For you as a nigga, you know what I'm saying? You, for real, you at the bottom of the totem pole. You the lowest of the low. So for you to actually stand up is a little bit more significant. You understand what I'm saying? And years of being, tortured by feminism, especially in the matriarch, that's another thing. You're experiencing it from another view. You're in the matriarch. You're going to have a more executive, direct, straight one-hit kill, you know what I'm saying, answer to shit. Whereas the other dude that's in the patriarch, he'll be like, okay, well, I got a little bit of game, but there's another side to this that I'm not getting. You'll get the whole side. You understand what I'm saying? There's a gap there when it comes down to it. And it could be good, bad, right, or wrong. But never mind, man. So, look, you create MGTOW. You created MGTOW. This is a MGTOW rant. You created MGTOW. But listen to how far left they go, because they're under the impression that white men create MGTOW. When you do your research on the internet, you will see, you will mainly run into the white MGTOW. Now, the white MGTOW, he's going to be doing the most. He's going to be, you know what I'm saying? You know, that's, some of those dudes are not MGTOWs, you know what I'm saying? Some of those dudes just have a complex, or they got a little bit of game, or whatever. But, anywho, you'll do, if you do a quick research on MGTOW, you're not going to get the full thing. This is something that's going to take you years before you come around to being like, oh, okay, I get it now. You understand what I'm saying? MGTOW and listening to Red Pill content is a study. It's a study. That's why I name a lot of the episodes that I do study. Study 11 comes out tonight. We're going to be talking about a lot of the dudes that are taking red pills and getting around this content and, you know, want to learn a little bit of game. We're gonna give you a moral standpoint by listening to clips from my boy Darius M. Shout out to Darius M. And we're gonna give you a more practical, direct strategy to go after the type of women that you want, because usually it's the women that lead you niggas to this type of information. Some broad done did something to you emotionally or financially or something like that. And then, you know what I'm saying, you go off on a tangent like, man, fuck that bitch. You know what I'm saying? Because for real, fuck that bitch. And then a lot of you niggas start listening to a lot of these dating coaches and things like that. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of this shit is just dudes in seek of game or dudes in seek of an answer. And they know other men have gone through it. And they're listening to a great conversation and picking up some knowledge on the way. So listening to this. I'm gonna just let the good times roll. Come on.
I have Roxages here with me again for this video, and I really want to get a male's perspective on this topic.
We can be here all night, nigga.
We're gonna be talking about MGTOW in this video. We have got
MGTOW.
Well, yeah, we both.
Y'all don't even know what you're talking about. Check this out.
Together, but I've been getting requests for this video since like I first got back on social media, like, you know, back.
Somebody timestamp it right here.
I didn't ignore it.
I was ranting
it.
Like shit.
I'll get back to it, you know, because I didn't know what it was. You know, y'all know I was gone for social media from a long time, like over a year. So this whole MGTOW talk, this whole red pill movie, I didn't know what any of this was. And so I didn't really want to be a part of it either, to be honest.
So she didn't know what it was, and basically she's saying she didn't even really want to try to figure out what it was. And that's another thing, too. MGTOW got a... When you learn what MGTOW is, they have a real big complex on y'all. One, you really did some half-ass research, because you're not going to do full research if you really have no interest in what it is. It's like, okay, let me just go look up, you know, one or two little articles, and, oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, this is what it's about. Okay, let me go make a show. No. You can't look up an article or two or different people. You have to be around this information. You have to hear the type of conversations and the type of game and the science that's being chopped up in the middle of it. So just the fact, that's just another fun fact of the shit. You know what I'm saying? The fact that you don't even care to listen is basically a disrespectful slap to a lot of these brothers. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, you know, even your father. A lot of motherfuckers' fathers are MGTOWs. Don't even know it. It's like, damn, that's... When you hear some of the shit that's being said in these groups, especially the black side. I stay on the black side, but I do go on the other side, too. I kind of listen to the conversations they're having in comparison to the conversations that we're having. I learn from them. I learn a lot of shit. It's dope. But what I'm saying is that, you know, It's so much shit to take in. And the fact that, you know, somebody would not do their due diligence to really, you know, really listen to some shit like this is, like, lame. It's like, you, oh, whack. You know what I'm saying? It's like, come on, man. So now you just about to have a whole, now we already know you about to have a whole smear campaign in this, that, and the third. Now, if you are laced with a little bit of game, the way that her husband is looking at her, he, you know, a real nigga would be like, well, baby, why are you going to speak on something that you kind of really don't know shit about? He would check her. See, like, if they were moving like a real, I'm not going to just judge the relationship like that, but yeah, I kind of am. No, nothing personal. I'm just talking about some real shit, okay? For the sake of her, what she intended, because she wants the best for herself, but she doesn't know it yet. That's why she choose a nigga. He should have been like, baby, well, if you kind of didn't do your research on it, just, you know. But then come to find out, he didn't do his research on it. So let's check this out.
I don't like stuff like that. But I kept like noticing like that in my comment section, men started to be very disrespectful to sisters. And that is not I am used to. I'm not used to seeing men disrespect black men. I'm not used to seeing brothers disrespect sisters in my comments, not on social media, not on YouTube, not Facebook, not Instagram. I'm not really used to it. And I mean brothers calling them bitches and hoes. I mean, just say very disrespectful, call them ignorant, stupid, whatever.
Right.
And one thing I noticed that all of these brothers had in common was that they were all repping this MGTOW movement, you know? And so I asked Roxanne.
They were all repping this MGTOW movement. Okay.
Because I was like, what is MGT? And he was like, Muslim Girl Training. And I was like, I don't think that's what it stands for.
Shout out to my brothers and sisters in the nation.
Right. And so we did some research and some investigating, watched a bunch of videos, did some Googling, read some articles and everything. And we found out what it was and what it was about. And it's men going their own way. And so we're going to give our perspective on it and what we think it is and what we think about it. And so... yeah, you want to start?
So we'll get to the positive first, because I think it's only right to be fair to just, you know, highlight some positives.
Okay.
I'm definitely an advocate for brothers getting more in touch with their masculine side.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Brothers becoming leaders.
Yeah.
You know, all of those things along that vein. I'm okay with that.
He going to say things that's biased to her, because she's like ad-libbing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, but pay attention, y'all. Pay attention to the game. And she's just looking at him. So he don't really want to. He on ice. He don't really want to, you know what I'm saying, already.
I think that's a good thing. And, you know, men should be encouraging men, especially younger brothers, you know, to become leaders and to chase your dreams and your goals and to be more purpose-driven.
You coercing.
I dig all of that.
Yeah, definitely.
So all the positive I got to say. So now, because that's all I saw. The rest is just silly to me, man. I got to be honest, because I want to know, men going their own way.
Here we go.
First of all, which way is that going? Like, where are you going?
All right. You see what I'm saying? Typical. And she get really excited at this point. Oh, yeah, they about to shit on MGTOW. Here we go.
Yeah.
You keep saying you're going your own two way, fam.
Where and you from going,
judging
yo?
From a lot of the rhetoric that I see, where they say, you know, don't fall in love with a woman, don't get in a relationship, don't have children, don't be a stepfather. I just want to know, is the direction that you're traveling...
Okay, now, let me just ask you a question. If a person chooses not to do that, what's wrong with that? If a nigga say, I don't want to be a stepfather, what's wrong with that? If a nigga say, yo, I ain't, you know what I'm saying, I ain't trying to, you know what I'm saying, get married right now until I'm established. And I literally can't do it with a woman. A woman will distract me in achieving my goals and dreams. Then some will argue, oh, well, you got to meet the right woman. Yeah, yeah, that's nice, but yeah, let me just do it my way. What's wrong with that?
It's just silly to me. Where you going? Is it going to be women there when we get there? Like, if I wanted to be a part of this.
Is there going
to
be women there when we get there? He's pandering like shit. Like, really, why would you just, like, you think niggas just going to go off, hey, because I want to be with boys. No, man. Come on, man. And niggas think like that too, because everything is like to attack the heterosexual male. But this nigga's like, is there women gonna be there? That's simpish, man. When's the last time, when's the last time your boy like, man, come on, let's go somewhere, right? And yeah, like, bitches be around. Like, sometimes you and your nigga be like, yo, you know what I'm saying? We gonna be around some bitches. But you could be like, yo, hey, come, yeah, just come to the crib. We gonna chill. We gonna talk about some shit. And then we gonna, you know, make our moves or whatever, right? Boom. Or just chill. Like, you just gonna chill. Don't no nigga be in a rush to, yo, man, you know who could tell a good joke? My girl. You know, man, I just won't be around my girl. Sometimes it's like, man, she stay over there. Let me get my alone time over here type shit. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's the same thing. Like, I played that Patrice O'Neal clip. We want you to be there, but just not around us sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Happens. But who am I to tell this nigga what to say? Because he in a marriage. You know what I'm saying? And I respect them, and I respect the marriage. I'm just talking in general, because this ain't the first couple to say this shit. I got way more clips I can show to prove my point. But let's finish it. Let's check it out.
Organization. My question would be, which direction are we traveling in?
Yo, where we
and
going?
Are there going to be
and
women?
Are there
going to
be women there?
Because if we're going in a direction that does not involve women,
so you're
at
implying
the destination,
that niggas are gay.
Or children,
there
I don't
go.
Want to have nothing to do with
get
that.
Get it
shit
out, my nigga.
At all. It sounds like some Peter Pan little boy shit to me, like some Boy Scouts for like 45-year-old men.
Mm-hmm.
And that's another thing, too. So if them niggas are already in the conversation and talking about, yo, don't get married, you know what I'm saying, because you need to chase your dream. Okay, good. Now you a nigga with a standard. You understand what I'm saying? Don't do this because blah, blah, blah. Good. Now you a nigga with a standard. It makes important sense that you as a man have a standard. You understand what I'm saying? Broads will tell you they like this type of nigga. You find them, they dating this type of nigga. Niggas will say they like that type of bitch. They don't stop them from liking that type of bitch, because sometimes you find them with another bitch on the way up to get the other bitch. You understand what I'm saying? Sometimes you gonna find a nigga with two fives and shit to get a dime. What do two fives get you? It gets you a dime. So maybe the nigga may not have the most attractive bitch, but if he got two fives, he got himself a dime. Come on, man. You don't want me to start getting into the ism. You don't want me to start getting into the ism. And like, bitches like when I talk that fast money fly man shit. Let's get
mm-hmm. Bitter men who reflect, just from the masculine perspective, the same thing that feminists do. You know, it seems like a lot of men who are not holding themselves accountable. If you've been through five relationships, brother John.
And that's another thing. Hold yourself accountable, man. Grow up. Go marry that girl. Give her a ring. Hey, turn around. Yeah, forfeit on the mortgage. You niggas will tell you that. Yo, you spend your money on her. Hey, 30% of your check needs to go to her or that ring that you're going to buy her. Hey, grow up. Give her some kids. Hey, you don't have kids yet? Why haven't you given her some kids? Damn, nigga. You know what I'm saying? I think last time I checked, I paid the bills. Last time I checked, you know what I'm saying? I got to get up and do shit. Last time I checked, I got to fuck the bitch. Last time I checked, I house the bitch. Last time I checked, I take the bitch out on a date. Last time I checked, this my car. Last time I checked, oh, this went out. Last time I checked, hey, this got paid. This didn't get paid. What's going to happen? Last time I checked, I'm a leader. I'm a man. I'm a shot caller. Don't tell me what the fuck to do. You don't sit up there and you tell no man to man up and go marry some stupid ass bitch that you don't know nothing about. Cause you up there, you ain't got no game. What type of shit you talking about, bro? What's wrong with these niggas, man? Oh, and then look at the dating climate that we're in right now. Oh boy, if you out here with any type of standards, bro, you already in a alpha male scarcity mindset. Shout outs to Alpha Male Strategies, man. You in a scarcity mindset because, bro, dog, I'm just telling you, once you expose to the true nature of a woman, I am telling you, you are not going to, the fantasy of the type of bitch that you want, it just crumbles day by day. You just know you're not going to get that bitch. It's like, okay, she look good, but damn, her personality some shit. Okay, she look good. Okay, she's cool. Damn, she did some stupid shit. Yep, that's the stupid shit. There she go. That's where she redlines. That's where she maxes out. It's like, it happens. And for them, you too. You know what I'm saying? We not condemning nobody. Some niggas like, yo, the bitch did some stupid shit because I did some stupid shit. A nigga will sit up here and tell you that the bitch did some stupid shit, but then, you know, a real nigga will reflect back on himself like, man, she did that dumb shit, but you know what? I seen it coming because I didn't check her when she did it this time, so I taught her how to treat me, and now she's treating me a certain way because I didn't check her. And initially, if I had listened to the gut feeling in my stomach that I ignored to check this bitch on some shit, and I did not do it, she has plausible deniability to do whatever the fuck she wants to do, whether she knows she's doing it on purpose or not on purpose. You understand what I'm saying? She has plausible deniability. Because the fact that I did not check her on that shit, now she looks at me as a simp. And if I don't care about what this bitch thinks or does, I don't give a fuck how she looks at me, it's gonna take me a little bit more to climb out. And then I kind of seen what type of woman she is because I know she does some of that shit on purpose. And I know she's using plausible deniability. I should be turned off because for real, this ain't shit. I have to put the relationship on hold to get you out of this dumb shit so that we can actually move forward. And you think that's working to build a relationship when that's not actually working to build a relationship. You're just making problems that could, you're just making self-inflicted problems on the relationship that could, you know, could have been handled already, and we could have been gone on to some better shit, and this is what you want to hold up the relationship with. That should kind of turn some of you niggas off. For real. If you understand what I'm saying. That should kind of turn some of you niggas off. So some of these niggas are like, you know what? The juice ain't worth the squeeze. Let me just start over with a new bitch. Because there's no way this motherfucker right here is going to respect me. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to create some distance. It's some distance that's about to be created around this bitch. Alright? I'll see you later, bitch. You know, absence make the heart grow fonder. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes, too, you know, when I'm in your presence, you don't respect my presence. So for you to respect my presence, I'm going to decline my presence. I'm going to remove my presence. And if you won't respect it while it's there, maybe you'll respect it when you figure out the depth of it not being there. Maybe it's like, damn, he used to be around me all the time. You know when somebody say he used to be around me all the time, and then damn. You know what I'm saying? It's funny how strangers turn to friends, and friends turn to strangers. But you know what? It happens. So yeah. They understand all this shit. Hell, these two people right here might not even be together next week. You understand what I'm saying? So, and I just described to you a relationship. Somebody will listen to that and be like, damn, that's the truth. Some people will listen to it and be like, what are you talking about? Some people will listen to it and be like, oh, this nigga's a dumbass. Oh, some people will be like, oh, you know what I'm saying? That does make sense. Damn, I didn't think about it like that. Damn, oh, I'm just getting laced. Whatever you got from it, take that. That's just one route. So, MGTOWs know this. Certain things are going to just lead you to the motherfucker. You understand what I'm saying? Because now, everything that I just explained to you, I could break that down again. I can go right back over. I can, you know, I'm like, how do you want it? How you want it chopped up, son? You know what I'm saying? So, what I'm saying is that mindset happens. Juice not worth the squeeze. MGTOW is saying, nigga, the juice ain't worth the squeeze. Because look at it. In the black community, look at the black woman. All right? She's taunting you, talking shit. Plausible deniability all up and down the board. Just in general, there's a plausible deniability that is game that is broken down when you take the red pill. We're going to talk about it later on tonight's show. I need to finish this clip, though. But this thing here, what it does is it creates a movement. And in the black community, the black woman is in shambles right now. She is in denial, and she's in pure denial of the shambles and in pure denial of the damage she's caused, or her, you know, share of the, you know, of you know, this pie that we have called the black community. And black men know this. Black women know this. But it just goes on when we just keep going back and forward. Cool. But she's in shambles. You know, when you're hanging off a ledge and you're like, now it's like, it's not funny now. Like, now it's like, all right, bitch, you got to do something now, right? Because it's even out of the niggas' hands. Like, more niggas would want to simp and trick and save you, but it's like, now, bitch, nah. Now you're taking it to a level where it's like, bitch, I don't, now you're going to have to pull yourself up. You know what I'm saying? And there's a chance that the nigga could pull you up. Because niggas are in shambles. We're in shambles because a woman are in shambles. You know, you're only going to produce... You have to see how you're producing. You're only going to produce what you produce. And the woman is the producer. I mean, the man produces the sperm, but the woman produces the offspring. And they're in a position where they're like, okay, now you need help. They're not even trying to. They're so prideful. They're not even trying to ask for help. Like, hey, man, look, I fucked up. Yo, can you give me a hand? You know, please, it would be nice for you to give me a hand. They're like, no, they want to shame you into, you know what I'm saying? You into giving them a hand, more resources, more. They just want to shame, as if them shaming you hasn't gotten you and them to that point. Them shaming you has gotten you to a point where you're like, yo, you a fucked up ass motherfucker, yo. I'm not about to. You know what I'm saying? Them shaming you got to that point, and their last ditch effort, like your last ditch effort, is like, damn, we would respect if you at least try to reach your other arm up and slipped and fell. Or we would respect if you know what I'm saying, you put your other arm there to kind of help and reached out for us. Like a lot of well-to-do good brothers that want to help the sisters out and shit like that do. They think like that. Damn, we would expect you to reach for us. But do they get that? Do they see, this is what I'm saying. It shatters a lot of you niggas. Like, when you wake up to the reality of what's going on, it shatters a lot of your mindset. You sitting up there, you thinking like, yo, man, I just know deep down inside my bitch love me, yo. She was on that ledge, yo. She gonna reach her other hand up and reach for me. And she doesn't even reach for you. She lets go of the ledge like, your mama black. And just fades into the darkness. Your mama black. Yo, she don't even give a fuck. She not all women are like that. She fades away like you see the darkness engulf her, and it's like, damn, yo. You sit up there thinking your lady gonna reach out, you know, it's like, damn, yo, I did so much for her, you know what I'm saying? You know, because there's so much simps in the black community. These niggas are fulfilling these women's needs, bro. They are fulfilling these women's needs. There should be no reason why these... Dog, it just goes to show, son, you can never make them happy, son. For real. And some niggas, they've been through the ringer. Just ladies, it's out there. Let's just, the cat's out the bag. Let's just be for real for a good damn minute. God damn it. Hold on, son. You're getting what you want. These bitches, they getting flued out. You know, these women, they get the cream of the crop niggas. Like, all the reason why you little MGTOW niggas, some of y'all, the reason why y'all exist, or some of you new niggas that's swallowing this red pill, is because women, niggas aren't getting played like that. They're not getting played. When women say niggas, they talking about us, but they talk, see, look, it's niggas to women, and then there's niggas, like niggas. You dig? It's hard to break this down. But only a certain percentage of black men are getting play like that. The simps get the play. The simps pick up the scraps. And the alphas get the play. So a certain percentage of black men are getting play. Women gotta go for the cream of the crop, niggas. Like they gotta you know what I'm saying? And sadly, some of those niggas live a certain type of lifestyle that some of you niggas don't agree with. Some of you niggas are, you know, ex-niggas that's been in that lifestyle. Some of you niggas are dudes that get girls every now and then, but you got a trick. Some of you dudes, you know, it could be anything. Not all niggas in MGTOW are incels. They're not niggas that can't get laid. They're not virgins. They're not dummies. They're not, you know what I'm saying? That's why I'm making this show purposely long and going on these goddamn rants, because for some reason somebody gonna hear this shit and it's gonna stick in y'all heads, man. So I wanna kinda enlighten you more before I finish this fucking clip, because the thing is that it's just, this shit is laughable. So this is like your mother and your father looking down to you, and they're gonna shame you. Yo, you know what I'm saying? Don't chase your dreams. That's basically what they're telling you. Parents be destroying their kids' dreams and shit. Don't chase your dreams. Don't. They'll reprimand you, because you know when you go out and go, you know, in the world and you understand how shit goes, you know, you'll see, you'll kind of get a glimpse, become an adult and see how far your parent has gone or could have gone. Or, you know, their magnificence, you know what I'm saying? In a certain area of life or certain subjects and things like that. And then some of y'all would just flat out see, oh, damn, my mother ain't shit. Some of y'all, it happens. Some of y'all see, y'all get to an age where it's like, okay, well, I'm kind of in the realm that my mother was. Okay, she had kids right there, so this is kind of where her shit stopped. This is where it could be for her. Oh, this could have been her experience, or this, that, and the third. Some of y'all are spot on because you have other examples around you in your life that will show you that shit. Some of y'all have nieces. Some of y'all have nephews. Some of y'all, you know, every day, if you just pay attention, you're learning different things. And the thing is that you'll kind of see how other people carried, you know, their adult status, you know, with the advantages they had then, or the disadvantages, or the advantages that you have right now, or the disadvantages. You know, you get to study variations. You get to deal with different types of women and things like that. You get this third eye of game. But what happened is, you'll just start to see. Listen to these shaming tactics that's about to come with it. MGTOW, I encourage y'all to go to MGTOW. Until further notice, I'm telling y'all, go to MGTOW. Go look up MGTOW content. Educate yourself and become that upstanding black man that you need to become. Because these niggas ain't gonna tell you the real shit. Not these niggas per se, but niggas like that kind of talk this rhetoric. They're the type of niggas that be like, oh, well, man, I'm so pro-black. Yeah, I'm about building and all this other shit. And then you ask them to do something, or you ask them about a certain knowledge of game in that certain area or that certain sector. And then you'll kind of see, okay, well, you're not even really kind of up on, you know, what you're talking about. And then I can tell where you're going to kind of draw your line when it comes down to that thing. So, you know, you're not even on what you're discussing when it comes to, like, you know, black politics and things like that. You know, you can't, there's certain conversations that I can have with you and it'll get heated, because, you know, your inability to have the capacity of knowledge in that, in that area of information. And not saying, and it's not looking at people saying they're dumb or not they're smart. It's just, you just didn't study about some of that shit. You're just, you're not stupid. You're just uninformed. You know, it's just to give you information. So I want you guys to, you know, listen to this with a grain of salt about, you know, when people that aren't even, you know, that are still learning, everybody's always going to be learning, but when people are, you know, conveying knowledge, sometimes you got to learn how to, you know, eat the meat and spit out the bones a little bit with what they're saying. It's like, okay, I could tell this person probably didn't look up too much about, you know, building, because this nigga gonna start talking about pyramids and kings and Nefertiti and all this other shit, and it goes back into that whole Nature Boy shit that I done broke down. It's gonna go back into that whole shit. It's like, yeah, you want to build castles and kingdoms? He gonna make her polygamous. He gonna make her polygamous at the end of this. Keep looking at him like that, shorty.
Whoever these guys
I'm
are,
I'm gonna introduce another
guys.
Joint to the
You've
joint.
You've been through five
yeah.
relationships, and every relationship you got played. That does not mean that every woman would do that. You probably would do yourself.
And a lot of these niggas, you really gotta understand, they take on the talking points of women. These same talking points, because MGTOW be going into women's chats, and they can be a menace. Some of these niggas, like I said, they aren't MGTOW, but some of them do. They see these same talking points. And it's even worse when the nigga use the same talking points, because then, you know, it's a talking point that comes out of emotion. So then now you got to battle that emotion with logic. So do you really feel strong on what you're saying, or are you just saying that just to say it? See what I'm saying?
Better service if you put the mirror in front of your face and said, you know what? What could I have done different? Was I being a pushover? Was I being a masculine?
And see, MGTOWs have asked themselves that. MGTOW is reflective, but if you don't understand that, you'll believe... It's like you're underestimating their knowledge and their information of shit.
Man, was I being a leader? Was I being the best version of myself? Because I'll tell you that once you start to become the best version of yourself, you get in tune with that, you will find good women, because they are out here. And the same thing I think... I'm not here to give feminist women no advice, other than just don't block me in or bunch me in with all men. I'm just speaking on MGTOW.
Right.
Excuse me, because I keep pronouncing that wrong. I keep saying MGTOW. I don't agree with anything that's going to exclude women 100%. Right? Now, don't get me wrong. If fellas want to go out and have a damn fishing trip together, that's peace. You want to go play some football, some basketball, have a, you know, at the man cave, kicking it, this, that, and the third. There's nothing wrong with that. That's brotherhood. You know, that's cool. It's camaraderie. I'm digging it.
That's MGTOW, sir.
That every once in a while.
Yeah.
But this cannot be the every night.
For the rest of your life.
This should only be maybe once, twice a month. My brothers and Noah, ain't it?
Who said that is every... Oh, boy.
Give him a comment down below, because I know
he's going to keep calling y'all
we
niggas gay.
We don't got time to be getting together every damn night. We
I
have
wanna
no time
be around
for
women.
Nor do I want to see you every night, brother. I just want to know you're safe, and you're being productive, and I'm okay with that. But this MGTOW thing starting to seem like some type of, like, boys club or some type of, like, Peter Pan fuckery. I'm not digging that. I'm not digging it. And you can't call yourself a true leader and a true masculine man if you're still running around here pointing the finger at women to say, this is why I have not been able to accomplish my goals.
All right. See, he's speaking vicariously to her. She's like, yeah, he's so educated. He's talking that shit. And then, you know, and then the funny part is that bra's going to be listening and then be like, yeah, see, yeah, man up. You need to grow up. What the fuck are you talking to?
You're not a leader then.
You're not a leader, yo.
Now, don't get me wrong.
Go in your own way. Insist that you're doing your own thing. You go in your own way. You're a leader. You're going your own way. When you have a pack of wolves, and you have an alpha wolf in the pack, and then you have to have another wolf that went his own way, did his own thing, and then now, boom. Some of y'all in this room right now, some of y'all are Nature Boy fans. Why were you a fan of Nature Boy? He went his own way. He left the States and went to the tropics and went and started his own tribe. He went his own way. You understand what I'm saying? Go your own way. What's so hard about... Never mind.
Oh, I understand that. What, how I view it is this. You can be in a relationship with a woman that could definitely slow you down. The same way a woman could be in a relationship with a brother that might slow her down. But you can also be in a relationship with a woman, you know, from the brother's perspective, that will greatly expedite your process as far as achieving your goals and becoming this king of this empire.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You find the right one. Ain't that right, though?
Right.
You find
ain't that right, baby? Ain't it the truth, huh? Baby? You gonna meet me? You gonna reach up on that ledge? See, she gonna reach up on that ledge, see? See, I got a smart one, see? So brothers, see, you know?
Find the right one, she'll help you get there.
Yeah.
So I don't understand it, man. I just, like, I'm not...
And then, see, and then, look, if they go over the podcast, this podcast, if it, see, that's that little boy shit. He wanna be a boy. He wanna... Hey, nigga. Stop. You need to man up. You need to marry. You need to know shit. Yo, these niggas kill me, son. don't it make it sound like I'm on some little boy shit. I ain't on no little boy shit. Niggas be grown ass men out here. And niggas, all these niggas gonna try to do to y'all little MGTOW niggas, they gonna try to son you. That's what they trying to do, nigga. They trying to son you. Yeah, yo, man, you need to treat her right, buy her rent, get her a house, move her out her mom's house, and the other kids that she got with her. Team Jackson here. That's all he got to say. He's Derrick Jackson. This nigga is Derrick Jackson. Listen.
Digging the energy, I'm just going to keep it a band.
Yo, I'm going to keep it 100, yo.
And I certainly...
Get that girl a house, Mo.
I feel like most of the reason why, you take it how you want to take it.
Yeah.
The reason why a lot of these Catholic priests out here touching little boys... Because you taking this dumb vow to sell...
Bro, what are you talking about, son? Son, you're talking about Black MGTOW. This nigga talking about something. The reason why the Catholic priests are touching these little boys? What are you talking about?
Celibacy, one. Why would you do that? That don't even make sense. Well, you think God just gave the creator, the source, the supreme, whatever, Lord Jesus, Oludumare, whatever you believe in, right? Gave you a penis to just never use?
She up there biting her lips and shit like that. Like, what the hell is this? Like, is this a serious talk about MGTOW or just one of y'all sexcapades, bro? Yo, man, he just looks so good when he talking on camera. That's that shit I like. Wait until he get off this goddamn, this damn podcast. Yeah, yo.
Who's it, G?
Yeah.
Nah, but you taking these vows and then you run around with these men all goddamn day every day for the rest of your life.
And then niggas, and then the funny part, niggas like this will come back, yo, see, if you learn how to make a woman do that, like, nigga, get the fuck out of here, son. bitches be come on here, yo, if you knew how to make a woman, nigga, if you knew how I knew how to make a bitch do that shit. What are you talking about, son? Get out of here, son. Son, I literally had this happen. Like, niggas will respond back, yo, if you knew how to make a woman look like this, like, nigga, I'll make a bitch look like that right now. What are you telling me, son? If you knew how to sustain a woman, look. To a degree, I understand what single people are talking about. Married people talk the most shit. It don't take nothing to figure out one motherfucker. You understand what I'm saying? Actually, that's what you really need to do. Really figure out one motherfucker. But if you, like, not everybody's marriage is gonna work the same. Dude, I have a, also, I wanna play, probably on tomorrow's show, I have a clip about lesbian divorce rates. Lesbian divorce rates are through the fucking roof. That's hilarious. Like, the stats on that shit is out right now. And it's like, damn. Like, really, people are counting that? Like, I didn't even know. But, I mean, it makes sense. I didn't even know lesbians had a divorce rate. Hell, I mean, I knew broads were getting married. But, you know, people don't even, like, really get married. But I guess once those laws were written, bitches really got married like shit. And, yeah, their divorce rate is through the roof. And I think, because Because another MGTOW did the video, Sandman, my boy Sandman. Shout out to Sandman. Sandman did the video for that, and he was saying that I think he's talking about white lesbians. I don't think he's talking about black lesbians, but I would imagine this too happens in the black community, because black women they're the majority of the lesbians, like they're the biggest lesbian population and things like that. And a lot of that stuff is all politics, why it's like that, because the thing is that when you're in a matriarch and you can indulge in different type of things and you have the internet and social media and things like that, you don't necessarily have to date out of necessity. You can just date a nigga because he wore green contacts or some shit, or some dumb shit. So the dragon shirt, you know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying is that, you know, they can jump into any kind of fuckery or foolery, especially in the matriarch. You understand what I'm saying? So, that's going to be interesting. We're going to go over that, too. But let's get back into the shaming. This nigga about to tell you about priests and shit.
And you become a...
Yo, this priest going to rape this little boy. And it's going to make you MGTOW, man.
All perverted up here, because that's not who you are built to be. You are built to be in the presence of queens, fam.
You are built to be in the presence of queens. I agree. But the debate I would ask, or the question that I'm pretty sure this he would debate on this, is, are these women of today acting like queens? Now, don't get mad at me when I say that. That's a loaded question. That's a loaded statement. But I would ask him in the middle of what he's talking about, I'll ask him that loaded question. And he's going to have to go in a whole different direction, because he's going to have to unpack. Boy, you're going to have to unpack that. Because if you say yes, now I know you're full of shit. Because then you know what's coming right after that. So you're telling me every single woman that you encounter is a queen. Then that's when he going to start copping, please. No, all right, you got some thoughts and you got some sluts. Okay, all right, stop right there. You got some thoughts and you got some sluts, right? Right? They out here. Let's just keep it a band. Come on, man. Let's keep it a band. They out here. How do you imply that we handle that? Yo, man, start hanging around men. Be real men. You know, hang, you know, do man shit. You know, do blah, blah, blah. Okay. Now, you know, it's just going to keep stacking, man. It's just going to keep stacking. So, let's listen to him explain that. How you're not real men. Popes be raping little boys and shit like that. I don't know black popes and black little boys. Never mind.
Two popes.
And we pro-black and fuck the white man. That's the...
Ain't nothing wrong with sex. So again, when you start to give me this talk about never fall in love, keep women out of your life, you'll never be able to accomplish
it. So he's just niggasplaining.
Goals and your dreams. I'm not with that. And I think, not only do I think it's harmful, but I certainly think we don't have room for it respectively in the black community, because we don't have time for anything that's furthering dividing man from woman, woman from...
Yo, we need to get back to loving these queens. Nigga, we are at war. What the?
Man, because we know that, and I'm not going to rant, but we know that when you combine the masculine and the feminine, listen, everything in nature has a positive and negative aspect to it. Everything in nature. Uh-huh. Everything. And so even if you break it down to the basic, like...
That's how they confuse you. Yo, if you do these mathematics, because, you know, pi is, I don't know that number, but you know what I'm saying? When you break it down, it equals the pie of the black community. Now, which slice of that pie you got? We have no room for MGTOW in this pie.
Molecules, right? Everything has positive and negative.
Down to the yin and yang,
right? Positive, negative, right? And so we know that when you, as original people, who we are, the chosen people, however you want to put it.
Mothers and fathers of civilization.
Mothers and fathers of civilization.
I'm gonna ride my wife.
The supreme seed. We know when we combine that masculine and feminine energy, that's when you get that source power, that what we call God. right? So there has to be, in my mind, somebody sitting back, somebody puppeteering this shit, putting these organizations out here in our community, because like the Queen said, and you said this before, we don't represent the leadership.
All right. White men did not put MGTOW in the black community to destroy the black woman, okay? Number one. Number two, black men created MGTOW. We created MGTOW. Okay? You telling a brother, look, yo, get back to loving these queens. That's still a man going his own way, because if a nigga get back to loving these queens, he just gonna totally ignore his finances. And some niggas will have it that way. I can't talk myself into these drawers. I'll buy the bitch. Bitch, what's your price? You dig? Fuck all the bullshit. How much? You know what I'm saying? When you get a wife, you know what you're saying? You know what I'm saying? Sometimes when some of these niggas... Why do you think the divorce rate is the way the divorce rate is? And why do you think it's mostly initiated by women? You say, yo, look, I done had a whole relationship with this bitch. I don't look. We've been together for a long time. I buy the bitch. I've paid my entry fee. I've purchased the bitch. She's mine. Let's get married. Then some niggas will be like, see, that's what you want. That's what you want. See, you don't want to go into marriage by thinking you own the bitch. Nigga, you a unit. You haven't you learned during the dating phase? She represents you. You represent her. You a unit. And if you want to be this quote-unquote leader like you say you would, I think you would really want to have it under control, because when that bitch can't lead and stuff, she going to look to the left and look at you. And when she looks to the left and look at you, you better have some type of plan. She ain't trying to hear that, yo, we together. Like, no, nigga, help me. Help me. You understand what I'm saying? What do I have you here for? You my whole husband, and you can't fucking help me. Bitches are in that position right now. Divorces are pending right the fuck now off the same shit. I'm just telling, man.
In the organizations, you don't see no black woman at the front of feminism.
Somebody going through hell right now.
You do trust she was put there. And the same thing for this MGTOW bullshit. They want us to completely keep separating. They want us to go this way. They want men to be going their own way and women to be going their own way. Because if we're going this way, then who's building the nation? Who's sustaining the empire?
Who's building a nation? Who's sustaining the empire? Nigga, what nation? Have you seen the black community lately? What nation? This nigga selling wolf tickets, son. What nation? What empire? Being dismissive and not understanding what the hell you talking about, or MGTOW, that's going your own way. That's fucked up. That's dismissive. That's not building a nation. Building a nation and be like, okay, let me kind of see where these brothers are coming from. Let this nigga be around some red pill shit. Oh, he gonna leave her. He gonna leave her. This nigga can sit in this car just like Derek Jackson. Wait till this nigga really get this shit and he's like, yo, I could really make money. I'm already talking this simp shit. You know what I'm saying? It's time to turn this shit into dollars. And then he sit in his car. And then him and Derek Jackson get into it. And... We still don't know if Derrick Jackson got legs, man.
Who's procreating?
Yeah.
Who's coming together to really give that God energy?
See the sisters are gonna love this shit, because they've duped themselves into thinking that all of them are queens. You know what I'm saying? There's no such thing as a peasant with them. So they and they all are queens. Theoretically, theory wise. It's great to think like that. It's great that, you know what I'm saying, but for real, in real life, it could tell you a different story. You know, it'll be dishonest if you really want to lie to yourself like that. So, my thing is, in theory, these words are going to sound... They're going to sound good. They're going to sound good to her. She can't even sit in a damn chair correctly. Like, she's getting stimulated. This is right here. This is what I'm telling you, the game that Yada, Nature Boy, all that shit. This is the game that they run. This nigga knows his wife. For real, like, I don't think he's just simping like that. Like, he got some, he's getting some tangibles out the shit too now. But, and they're a cute couple. Like, but this is what I'm saying. Like this is how, this is the gasoline. When you run out of this game right here, then I mean, the damage control, you can do that, but you gonna retain a certain amount of women. You know what I'm saying? But these bitches out here that be falling in love with this fake pro-black shit, these broads talking about, I can take your energy and read your vibe. Oh, I see. Yeah, they should be able to see through this shit. They should be able to see through this shit. Like, she thinks that this nigga's speaking life. This nigga just running a good game. He's not speaking life. Never mind.
So I know that was a long rant.
Well, I'm sorry, but listen. Yeah.
As a black man in 2019, I think you don't have no room for it.
The game is up, son.
You should not be that bitter, brother, that you jumping all in comments talking about bitches and hoes and this, that, and the third,
That's crazy.
Yeah, man. It's a shaming tactic. And this is another thing, too. We're going to read some of these comments. Some of these comments, you're going to find the game, all right? And then we're going to get out of the building, man. We're going to have the rest of the show tonight. It's Player Talk Radio. Hold on, let's get into it.
See, this is the thing, like, this is what I've seen in my comments. They'll call a black woman a bitch, but then turn around and call a white man their brother. And I've seen that literally in my comments.
And this is her trying to play the whole racist thing on you. Remember I told you sometimes that when they go together, when niggas and white brothers and everybody, there's niggas in Europe that is MGTOW. Niggas in Australia. Niggas all around the world that is in MGTOW. And they all come together. Hell, I'm in a group. Well, it's not MGTOW. But there's MGTOW dudes in the group that I'm in. I'm in a group started by Jay Norman called Guard Your Seed. Jay Norman also runs the page of Thoughts Men Aren't Supposed to Think. You understand what I'm saying? If you haven't heard of it organically, get your ass over there and come find me. You know what I'm saying? Go to Thoughts Men Aren't Supposed to Think and Guard Your Seed. But I think Guard Your Seed's an all men group, and men go there and we all discuss different problems that we're having financially, with women, with life, career paths, college, strategy. Women's behavior, memes, all kinds of shit. It's dope. It's fucking dope. You know what I'm saying? Niggas that lost, all kinds of shit. So.
Comment section. Like, the white man would be in that comments talking shit.
And we all get together and laugh. Like, it ain't no racism. It ain't no nothing. It's actually a brotherhood. It's actually, like, I mean, of course, racism is when you start peeling deep into these niggas' backgrounds and shit, racism is gonna be there, but for those little moments, it's like, yeah, man, we can coexist. Damn, yo, some bitches try to create fake pages and get into the group and kind of, because, see, women want to be in your space, fellas. Women want to know, if you know women, because these niggas claim that you don't know women and shit. If you know women, are nosy as shit. They want to leave a bitch in your house. She gonna snoop through all of your shit. You understand what I'm saying? Women know women and women don't trust women. That's why they know. They know how other bitches are. So if you think that you're going to come over here and just disagree with me, he think he knows. No, even you don't believe that bitch. You don't trust that bitch. That's why you don't trust another bitch around your man. Because for real, now you're like, damn, I know how women are. Let me see how far she got. That's how women get down. You understand what I'm saying? Let me see how far she got into it. Like, how far she snooping. When a woman confronts another woman about something, they're going to see how far they're snooping. And a lot of women are petty with their snooping. That's why if you listen to the show that I did before this, go to the show, Michi X versus Paris Milan, when those two sisters were going at it. You see how catty it was because they both petty with their snooping or what they're doing. You see one did homework, one didn't. One checked one on what one was saying, one didn't. You understand what I'm saying? They women are not dumb by a long shot. I don't know what's wrong with you niggas. But hey, they just didn't do their homework on MGTOW. both of them. As a man, I would have taken over the situation and made sure my woman was educated on what she's talking about before she get on the damn camera on her show and look like a whole fool when she's addressing other niggas. You understand what I'm saying? Because then that shows my inability to lead her as a man. If she didn't do too much thought into it, I would have been like, well, you know, we looked at a couple of things. This is what I saw. This is kind of my thoughts, even though he went left with it. He wanted to do the same thing, but it just didn't go that way. But, you know, what do you think about it? I think these are a lot of brothers that have been, you know, through different situations with women, and they want to sit down and talk about it. They don't have no place to breathe or, you know, go with these situations. Some of these niggas, they don't got no fucking father there. So why can't you learn the game from somebody that's been through it and that can further you than sometimes your actual biological father would have? Why can't you congregate with a whole bunch of dudes just to see, like, yo, man, you know, I keep getting used for my money. What am I doing wrong? Well, fella, you know, you got to understand that, you know, women know when, you know, you have a lack of game that you're going to have to pay for it. And some may respect you, but now you have a timer on your shit because now, you know what I'm saying? You know, whatever she think is going to go down with you is going to come from, you know, your money, because women are a certain type of way where if a guy starts spending money on him, she's going to diagnose him as the money nigga. And every time you're around, now you got to spend money on the bitch. Now when you take the bitch to the circus, these elephants could jump through these damn hoops. But next time when she comes out with you and you take that bitch to the circus, now you got to light that bitch on fire. You got to pay out your pocket for the goddamn kerosene that's going to go on the goddamn rope. So this elephant can jump through the rope for the bitch. And she sit there and yay! She claps and shit. And then, okay, you're going to take her out to eat. Oh, she don't like to eat that place. Now she wants to go to somewhere else. You don't have enough game to control none of that. See, you need game. You need knowledge. You need wisdom. You need not to listen to no shit like this. I don't know what this nigga was talking about. So now this woman is going to speak, say some more dumb shit. He going to ad-lib on the dumb shit, and she's going to kind of, you know, be coaching him and shit and getting happy and getting off. And that's it, folks. No game here. No, you know, close but no cigar.
Like, yeah, brother, and a sister leave her comment. He be like, bitch, you what?
You a fool.
Y'all crazy.
You a damn fool.
So let me go ahead and give my feminine perspective. Thank you for that masculine perspective.
I'm telling you too, nowadays, like with all this MGTOW talk and MGTOW jargon, like women don't really have the grounds to be talking about alpha males and beta males, because for real, that bitch gonna choose both. You dig what I'm saying? That bitch will prefer alpha males, but in the midst of her not being around no alpha male, or the alpha male don't want her, she gonna be dating simps and beta niggas and complaining about it. She not gonna tell you that part of the story. These hoes will never show you their dating pool. That's some embarrassing ass shit. You really wanna embarrass a woman? I mean, niggas know that they hit some ugly shit. Niggas can hit an ugly bitch. So what? Pussy could be good. You dig? Or whatever. Sometimes bitch will hit a nigga. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes ugly nigga got the better dick. It all matters with the chick. But there's a nigga in your bitch's past. There's one of these niggas. And some of y'all, it's a couple of them. In your bitch's past. And you will just look at her like, yo, what the fuck were you thinking? This is the little attitudes and shit that you about to give me right now. You dated this motherfucker, and this nigga just, even if it's a speckle, he contributes to why you act the way you do right now. Ain't that a bitch? Ain't that a... You can literally look at that nigga and be like, this is what you call a real man. At some point in your life, that's what it was, huh? You can literally clown them. And then sometimes, you know, sometimes y'all niggas be hitting some strags too. She could be like, yo, for real? That's how you feel? You know what I'm saying? You like, hey man, yo. Shit. We all, you know what I'm saying? I was going through a drought. And then, you know what I'm saying? That bitch was just around. How you saying? But I got my stroke game. You know? Let me stop. Let me stop. See, this is what happens when you have real topics and a goofy-ass nigga that's been through a whole bunch of real shit. You have a real-ass nigga. Sometimes you gotta make a motherfucker laugh about a situation. It's because it's funny. There's, like, a lot of irony in all of this shit that we're talking about. So, even it's just funny down to him simping for his wife and conveying this wrong information. But I'm telling you, if you hear a broad talk about some, yo, you know, he's a beta male and all this other shit, it's like, bitch, that's a loaded assumption. You have to break that down. Okay, what's a beta male? Because what will be an alpha male to one woman is a beta male to another woman. You understand what I'm saying? Sometimes, you know, some of these girls, you know, they wouldn't even date their girlfriend's niggas. Like, I don't know what she sees in that nigga, but look, as long as she's happy, that's cool. I wouldn't date the nigga. I think he's this, that, and the third. But look, they make each other happy, blah, 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 right? There's a such thing. So what I'm saying is that, you know what I'm saying, they really can't talk. Never mind.
Like, MGTOW and feminism are two sides of the same coin. I really feel like everything that feminism does for women is the same thing that MGTOW does for men. And when I say men, I'm talking about my brothers and I'm talking about my sisters.
Okay, now you can tell that's not true because the thing is that they're not two sides of the same coin. Okay. MGTOW doesn't get laws and stuff written. Granted that there's a lot of men's rights activists that are in MGTOW, but they kind of men's rights activists, which are the MRA, they kind of go out of their way to not be with MGTOWs. A lot of matter of fact, a lot of people are debating against MGTOWs that are actual MGTOWs right now. They just don't. They're just gonna be in the future wave because a lot of them just don't understand what they're talking about. And Obsidian being one of them, you know what I'm saying? And I was on Obsidian earlier today. This nigga rushed me off the shit, but I'll get back up with my brother Obsidian. Shout out to Obsidian. You have to understand, man. This shit is not the easiest information to take in. It's going to take people time. You know? And MGTOW is not feminism. The feminism that it, you know, MGTOW is not feminism. Okay? She thinks MGTOW has been around for a long time and niggas just joined it. She thinks MGTOW is like alt-right. A lot of MGTOW dudes probably are in alt-right. A lot of their philosophy is the same because they're men philosophies. And when they think about men, they think about just a patriarch where you're telling black men to be men, but when, you know, then you're chastising them for learning manly traits. As a man, you're supposed to save your money because that can save your family. That helps you become this amazing provider. As a man, you're supposed to chase your dreams because that can help your family. That can make you save. That can make you, you know, become a provider. As a man, you're supposed to open doors for women or do whatever you think you should do for women. That was chivalry. You know what I'm saying? That's what makes you a protector or whatever. But to actually protect somebody is to actually provide. So providing and protection kind of, you know, go hand in hand. That's why they both start with pro. Provide and protect. But what requires you to be a pro? Time. You gotta learn about your time. What are you doing to do with that time? Well, you gotta accumulate money. What do you gotta do to accumulate money? You gotta work. What does work require? Time. I'm not about to argue semantics with these niggas. Like, just let them be. That's why niggas go their own way. Unfortunately for you, black men, you go your own way first. That's just how it is.
When I say women, because that is where my concern lies. I didn't take a red pill or a blue pill. I've taken the black pill, and that's where my concern lies.
You didn't take the black pill.
And so, first of all, a lot of women join the feminist movement because they're bitter. You know, they may have had a bad relationship with their father. They may have resentment towards men. They might feel like it's a man's fault that they're...
That's not why women join the feminist movement. A lot of bitter women are in the feminist movement, but they didn't join because they're bitter. They're actually women that actually wanted laws, and they're actually women that actually had a good cause. They're actually women that actually had... You know what I'm saying? Real gripes that were against them at the time. They actually went into it with good intentions. But what happened with good intentions? The road to hell is paved with good intentions. You understand what I'm saying? The road to hell is paved with good intentions. Some of the powers that be took it and went all the way left with it. Now you got the LGBT. Now you got the, and I got some shit to play for that too. Now you got the LGBT. And there's a split going on right now. Now you got the feminist movement, you know, you got all of these different movements that are out here, these gender movements now. It morphed into something else. It's not always with bitter women. Now there's a bunch of bitter women in it. And some women, they just don't just join the feminist movement. Because guess what? The feminist movement is not just a movement. It's a mindset. It's a philosophy. Similar to MGTOW. One's right and one's actually wrong. It happens.
They're in the position that they're in or whatever. And so a lot of them are confused. They join this feminist movement that was not started for black women. It wasn't started for black women, and then black men aren't responsible for feminism, but they start, but they join that because they think it's going to empower them in some way. But what it ends up doing is making them less feminine, which actually takes them further and further.
I like how she conveniently leaved out how the black woman broke away from the community and left black men. She just conveniently leaved it out. She paused and just conveniently left out MGTOW, black women going their own way. They went their own way to the feminist movement.
Their way from their true power. Right. And these women become stressed. They become miserable. They're lonely. They're bitter. You know, and they're obnoxious. No man wants them. You know what I mean? And so, and a lot of them end up turning gay because they're like overly masculine, right? That's what's going on with this MGTOW movement. A lot of men are moving further and further and further away from masculine traits.
That is, wow. I'm sorry for you, MGTOW brothers. That is a slap, son. That is a genuine... Like, that's one of them slaps you thought you got shot. Like... That's one of them slaps you hear a ringing noise and shit. You know what I'm saying? You see a light or type shit. That's one of them epileptic slaps, bro. You know, that's what's happening. You know, you guys are turning gay. You're gay? And that's really all black women can do is emasculate. The shaming usually is an emasculation tactic. And unfortunately, a lot of you black men, you know, y'all gonna get emasculated. White women, they'll say some shaming or emasculating things to men, but they won't go as far as to insinuate that he's gay. And they'll say something to a man, but there'll still be some borderline straight shit. They'll be like, that's why your dick is small. Didn't say he was gay, but she attacked his manhood, but she didn't say he was gay. She said that his dick was small. Black women, they cut a little bit deeper. They go on the other side of the fence. You understand what I'm saying? Well, you weren't a man anyway, so you're with another man because you're a bitch. You understand what I'm saying? That's how they do it. Go look at half of the shaming tactics you're going to hear from a sister. They're some emasculating shit. They break the man. Sisters, and they're not going to take credit for it. I'll give them that. They're not going to take credit for it. I'll be the sacrificial lamb. I'll sound ignorant. They're not going to take credit for that at all. Cuz that's a loaded statement, which is true when you break it down. And the thing is that, you know what I'm saying? Those white feminists, the black feminist is usually gay. I'm going to just put that out there. A lot of the black feminists, they're actually usually gay because this is what she's trying to explain. The major form of feminism is lesbianism, you know, in its pure state. A bit of it is lesbianism. Like a woman will go so far and bitter that she'll start sleeping with other women. And you look at a lot of these black women out here, they've always been hurt. You can just assume the woman that you're going to get is automatically hurt. They come pre-hurt. You understand what I'm saying? You can literally walk up to her, look, baby, I'll make it better. Well, what are you talking about? Like, her last relationship could be good, but you were like, but the guy before him, he hurted you, so the man before you couldn't properly love you, right? See, now I'm about to run that conscious game on y'all hoes. Yeah, the last man before him, he couldn't love you right, so it threw off your Leo. Your Leo was in, like, the spirit of the fire of Aries, and then Aries, you know, it turned into a wind sign, and then Aquarius came. And those waters that the Aquarius man poured, it came out your eyes through your tears, and your tear ducts were, you know, crazy, and it left you unable to love the last man that you were with. But right now, I see the queen in you. I see the goddess in you, baby. You right for the picking right now, and I'm your knight in shining armor, and I'm here to tell you, you know what I'm saying? I'm here for you, and my armor is shining because I shined it up for you. Because a man that is a knight in shining armor, his armor that is shining has never truly been tested. But I'm here for you, baby, and I need you to test me so I can acquiesce and show you that I'm here for you. Like, they go into all that dumb shit. Just from that little bullshit I just said, I done got a couple bitches. I done wrapped some bitches in their chair right now at home, moving in their chair like this. Did I move the chat room? Hold on, let me check the chat. Check the chat. Yo, YouTube gonna kick me off. Whoever gotta sit back at YouTube gonna listen to the shit and be like, yo, you know what? I give them an A for effort.
That actually are required in order to be considered a real man. You know what I mean? Because, like, if you're going in a direction where there is no woman, no children.
Ladies, I'm sorry. I would not listen to what you believe a real man is, and you cannot blame me. And I can break that down too. And you're not gonna tell me what a real man is. I'm sorry. You're just not. You innately know that's not a decision you get to make, son. And that's what you fellas need to learn. You innately know that's not a decision they get to make. Right? Like, come on. Pay me what I'm owed. Pay me what I'm owed. Come on. The bag. Pay me. Well, how much are you worth? I don't know. That's up to you. You're a man. You're supposed to know. Well, when I place worth on you, then you say I'm judging you. No, because you can't place worth on me. Nothing can place worth on me. Okay, then what's your worth? I don't know. Just pay me. Come on. Come on, man. You niggas leaving these hoes a wiggle room to negotiate a price. Then you sit up there and pay the price, and then she looking at you stupid. Like, nigga, you dumb as shit. Why would you spend this on a hoe like me? Damn, you must really like me. Well, off to the next nigga. Off to the next bag. And then let's say if you do pay the price, and she doesn't live up to what she talking about, to that price or whatever. The price ain't right, my nigga. You understand what I'm saying? The price ain't right. Right? No Bob Barney. Right? Or Louis. Whatever happened to Louis? Where the fuck is Louis at? He probably somewhere in California in the house doing cocaine, shriveled up. Like, let me stop playing. Whatever happened to life with Louis, though? Anyway, even she won't respect you. You paid that price. Women, they be turning their niggas into tricks, man.
children, then who are you protecting? So by default, you're not a protector.
You need to grow up. You need to protect. You need to protect. MGTOW is protecting. They're talking about it. They have chats on it. Other dudes get the game and run their business. Business owners are MGTOWs. Niggas that own yachts. Oh, my God.
Right? Unless you're protecting men. You know what I mean? So you're not a protector. And
you're not a protector unless you're protecting men. Because, see, in your mind, men are disposable. Men are disposable. I already told y'all how women think, man. You look at what she's telling you. She's enforcing the idea. She's telling you that you have to provide a service. You have to do something. You have to man up. You have to. That's all you know. You're getting nagged. You have to, like, bitch. What are you doing while I'm doing this? Then that's when the problem starts. What are you doing while I'm doing this? While I'm at work and doing all this protecting and all this superhero man shit, what are you doing? What do you mean? That's all they ask. What do you mean? Bitch, you heard me. What the fuck are you doing while I'm out doing this shit? I'm not about to sit here and do all of this shit and you sit. Nah, I don't even trust a bitch nowadays, bro. Mm-mm. You gotta get a job, baby. Nope. Nope. Some of your hours gotta be accounted for because you're not about to have no attitude when I come back home because you've been sitting in the house all day not doing shit. That ain't about to happen. Nope. Unless I know you, unless I see your regimen or you have something else going on. No, for not right now, you're going to have to get a job. I'm sorry. Anywho, that's neither here nor there. You grow up with the whole incentive as a man that you have to offer the world something. And you do. As a man, you know, look, man, I got to work hard. I do different things. You know, I gotta, you know, deadlines and things like that. You got your shit cut out for you. Women, on the other hand, no. She sit up there, what can the world offer me? What can the world offer me? Including you, nigga. Because I don't feel the world is offering me my price. The world asks her, what's her price? What do you mean? I don't know. So, the only thing that she can take them little emotions out on what can the world offer me, is you. She plays that all on you. So when you offer her something, you become the world. See, it's easy for a woman to become a career girlfriend. But it's not easy for you to become a career boyfriend. You can't be a real career boyfriend. Yeah, you're loyal to your woman and you gotta do shit for your woman. But damn, you gotta work. Damn, you gotta chill. Damn, can I sleep? Damn, bitch, what are you doing? You know, smothering you and shit. The dick was good. Yeah, I know, bitch, but you go over there for a little bit. It always is good. Good for you. You said you weren't going to act stupid after I gave it to you. Now nigga done gave you the shit and now you acting stupid. You know what I'm saying? Want to call me 24/7 and stop my music while I'm I'm driving or some shit. Don't nobody want to talk to you? Don't you got shit to do? Like, they'll give up the nigga. They will literally give up their life for you. And if you sit up there and give up your life for her, they will judge you on that. They will leave your stupid ass. You know what I'm saying? And then now we living in a society now where everything's about money. Shit. You shitting me? Let you call out of work one day and stay home with that bitch. At some point throughout that day, she's going to be like, damn, he chose me over the bag. You think she really going to respect that? Like, if you really don't have your shit lined up, do you think that woman is really going to respect that? Yeah, you know, you did something for her, but you kind of did it at the expense of your manhood. You understand what I'm saying? You did, and not only did you do it at the expense of your manhood, a bitch like her ain't really used to niggas doing that. So a bitch like her really don't know what to feel in that situation because niggas really don't be doing that for that bitch. You know what I'm saying? That nigga that she really wants, that she's kind of using you or band-aiding you with, or whatever she has you around for, the nigga that she really wants would have been like, bitch, go take the walk of shame. I gotta go to work. Or what you about to do? Yeah, well, I'm gonna call you a little Uber so you can take your ass home while I go to work and shit. You know what I'm saying? Or some of the niggas would leave the bitch in the crib. Some of these niggas naive. Let us, man. Shit.
You're not providing for women or children unless you know, who are you providing? You're providing for yourself.
Give me.
For other men, who are you providing for? You know what I mean? And then as far as being a leader, you can't really call yourself a leader if you are following this group. And again, you're following a group that was founded.
How's she gonna tell you how to be a leader? You can't be a leader unless you're following this group. You're following a group telling you to go be a leader. You're following a group telling you to go your own way. It's in the name. Men going their own way. So if you're following a group telling you to go your own way, aren't you following a group that's based on some type of leadership? One of the most leadership thing you can do is tell somebody to go their own way. Do your own thing and I'll respect you for it.
Did by
such a shame
a European that does not look anything like.
Now we're being wounded by European because white people put MGTOW into the black community to disperse black men. Get the fuck out of here. IDMOR is a white nationalization organization group. Like,
you and that does not have good intentions for our community as black people. It really doesn't. And a black woman cannot respect a man that's following a European man. We can't respect that. I don't respect that.
Now she's trying to spew some racist rhetoric. You know, you can't follow the oppressor. Do your own thing under his own. Don't you think niggas been thought about this? Women have the ability to say something that is known most confidently, like she's the first motherfucker to say the shit. Like Nawalt, not all, N-W-A-L-T, not all women are like that. Not all women are like that. Go let a girl go say that in the middle of a debate. She gonna say it like she the first person to ever say that. All of these shaming tactics are outdated. And niggas aren't falling for it. Not no real MGTOW niggas or just niggas in general.
You know what I mean? And again, anything that is led by them and that's telling you to be further away from your people is.
This nigga in the background licking his lips because he like, yo, she running down the terms and conditions. This is what she want from me. This is what I made a vow to do. I went in front of the priest. You know, I'm Christian. And this is what I did.
It's not going to have the good intentions. It's going to be detrimental to.
That nigga don't have no rebuttal.
Especially our family structure, because we know the family is the foundation to everything else. And so not only is it making you less of a protector, less of a provider, less of a real leader, you know, you're following, it's making you less in tune with being a proud black man, you know? Really? In order to be a proud black man, you need to be able to have a black wife, black children that you can leave things behind.
In order to be a proud black man, you see how they define your existence? But if you ask her, look, baby, don't wear the makeup tonight. You can't control my vagina. Bitch, I didn't ask you all of that shit. What are you talking about? You can't control my vagina. He wants to control your sexuality, sis. This bitch just told you, and I'm sorry, I don't even mean to say it like that, because, I mean, not her personally, like, but I'm just saying. Because she's not the first person. I've heard this for about a stern decade right now. I've heard this for a good. I've heard this so much. I probably heard it for longer. But listen, I'm willing to take an extra 5 years off of that stern decade. So it ain't even 15. I heard a good 10 years of this shit. Word for word, like they all read from the literally, they all read from the same playbook. There's probably a clip of Cynthia G floating around saying the same shit 10 years ago because she's preaching this shit 10 years ago, probably. So, all I'm saying is grow up, have a wife, you know, just be a man, give her something, give her. That's your existence, man. And look, and we'll sit there like a big dumbass, just, yeah, you know, happy wife, happy life, you know, and whatever she want, man, you know. Oh, if this ever happens to me, play this back a couple years. Play this for me in whatever relationship I get into with my wife. Play this for me, and I swear to God, I'll snap back in character. This shit was so me. I'm making tapes right now for the future. Let's get it. Let's finish this shit before we get out of the room, man. I'm getting tired, y'all. And I know y'all getting tired, too, of me ranting. And I know some of y'all canceled him out. Oh, he a little boy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's that little man shit. Yeah, man. I don't know what he's talking about, man. Yep, you know what I'm saying? You know, just give it to her, man. You gotta raise the community. Understand, be a black man, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Then you go try to be a black man. Hey, don't do that MGTOW shit, man. That shit, that's the white man. He gonna try to swindle y'all just like the feminist movement. But hold on. I find it funny how a lot of y'all sisters are gonna say a feminist movement, but when niggas bring up the feminist movement and your actions and what y'all doing in the feminist movement, what are you talking about? No, we didn't do that. No. See, you're being ignorant, and you know what I'm saying? Intersectionality. They do all of that dumb shit. They deny it. So don't try to... See, MGTOW gonna really get y'all in the cobra clutch. MGTOW gonna get y'all in the damn angle slams and the ankle locks, man. Because now it's gonna have to... See, this is gonna make bitches go into damage control, because now they're gonna have to... They're going to have to a certain degree, admit that feminism is doing damage. And a feminist woman will still admit feminism is doing damage because she already has the mindset. It's not just some bitch going out at a rally and holding up a sign and saying, hey, man, and then going home single. Because that white woman, she sure enough going to go home to her man. She's like, yeah, I was on that bullshit. Yeah, we got a little bit of money, though. So, you know. So... And them white women, it varies. They'll go home to an alpha nigga, or they'll go home to a beta male provider. I get tired of discussing this game. Let's finish it up.
Time to inherit, you know what I mean? And we talk about empire building a lot. Mm-hmm. And who are you going to be building?
Empire? Who the fuck wants to... That's that fantasy land shit. You know, we're just going to build an empire and all that. Well, baby girl, we need an economic base first. You need brothers talking about some MGTOW. Let the nigga nerds go build computers and shit like that and bring black businesses to, you know what I'm saying? We need an economic first. How the fuck are you going to build these damn... There is a such thing as a bitch slowing a nigga down from progress. So if a nigga says, yo, I ain't trying to do no bitch, and then he goes get successful, what you gonna tell him? Because then now all the bitches gonna come. You'll lose money chasing a bitch, but you'll never lose a bitch chasing money, man. And if you lose the money, you can't run a business. Because it's a liability, not an asset. Oh, but then now we gotta go. Oh, well, if you had game, then he'll attract a queen. More imagery. He'll attract a queen that'll speak life into him. You know, when you're around a good woman. Okay, bitch. All right, that sounds nice. Show me this bitch. I'm tired. Show me this hoe. Well, talking like that, you'll never get her. And then you buy more wolf tickets. You know, she's just going to come and you're going to have to take her out, spend money, and then, you know, impress her. Like, it was times back in the day, women would acquiesce to men. They wanted to study. They wanted to learn from a nigga. They wanted to be astute wives. You don't have that nowadays. These hoes, man, what can you do for me? Can you pay me a bill? This is my Cash App. They come out the gate asking for money because they don't want a relationship. They'll rather turn you into a trick, because all of these guys, to a certain degree, the volume of guys that they interact with, there's a lot of nobodies. I don't mind a woman saying, yo, let me monetize some of these nobodies and get some things done, because that's what they do. And when you walk around in that confidence, you'll fall into anything. There's a lot of shit to fall around walking around that confidence. But see, when you own a pussy, later on, that's going to come into play. That's what other motherfuckers are going to be fighting over. You own a pussy, you own a certain amount of confidence that you just naturally not going to take responsibility for certain types of shit. And that's what happens.
Building an empire with, if you don't have a woman and you don't have children.
He's not gonna check her on this. Like, well, baby, how can you tell a man what to do when... Ooh, goddamn. Mm-mm-mm. How can you tell a man what to do when you yourself's not a man? Like, can you kind of break that down? Like, I can see if you agree with your woman. But at least you can do some damage control with your niggas and be like, well, baby, what do you mean? Can you kind of break that down? That's how you get your bitch. You be like, okay, well, let me see what type of nigga you gonna talk about. Let me see if I live up to that. Or, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes the bitch is just getting it straight, giving you instruction mode vicariously. This is what I expect. Because she been waiting to get that list out. She just don't want to tell you. And when you on the podcast with a bitch, she'll find the courage to tell you some shit. To say some shit on camera that she wouldn't say to. Never mind.
To leave things behind, so you don't have, you're not trying to leave a legacy or anything. No, I get that you think that this is going to empower you, but honestly, if you're just sitting around bashing women all day, there's nothing empowering about that, because it is taking your power away when you are putting the blame on someone else for your own fault. A lot of you are not accountable for what you do. And the same thing with feminists. They are not accountable for anything. They just want to blame men for everything. Men want to blame women for everything. And nobody's being accountable for their own actions. And you really give other people your power when you do that. You are basically saying you're not in control of your own actions. Really? You're not in control of your own choices, the choices you've made. Really? You know what I mean? Like he said, a woman can hold you back. A man can hold you back, but they can't just completely stop you unless you allow that. Mm-hmm. You understand? And then again...
And so for you not to allow that, let's break this down. I want that SpongeBob. The ho. So for you not to allow that, you go your own way. You go your own way. What's wrong with that? No, you need to be around women. Well, bitch, I can't handle these hoes right now. Let me go my own way. No. Bitch, leave me alone. Leave me alone.
And why are you attracting these type of people? You have to ask yourself that as well. Because who you are with is a reflection of who you are at that time. And so if you are attracting women that are no good, or as a woman, if you're attracting...
And that's another thing they do. They always hit you with, well, it's the type of woman that you're attracting. Well, in your mind, these women don't exist. So, I don't have no... See, they think you're a robot, my nigga. That you just don't get mad. And then these be the same motherfuckers. Get emotional. Show me your emotions. Like, dude, what's wrong? You know, you can express. You can open it up to me. See, this is why when you fall in love with a bitch, you hate the bitch. Because they will send you signals like this and you just gonna get mad and you... You know, I ain't about to go in the house. Let me circle the block a little bit. Let me go drink with my niggas real quick before I go home. Let me go smoke real quick, because this motherfucker right here. You sitting up there spending the whole relationship trying to save this bitch from herself. She can't even tell you thank you. She don't even realize the type of role that she played. She telling you to be emotional. It's like, bitch, you already have half my shit. If you don't know that by now, you need reassurance of that, then you really don't know who the fuck you dealing with. You know? Real talk, man. She walking around with a piece of your ego right the fuck now. Let that bitch get on social media right now and say something stupid or do something stupid. Sometimes, you niggas, y'all do have bitches that be on social media and they'll do something stupid. And some women will look at this and think the same about me, because they don't understand it. But... They'll just look at it and just be like, oh man, okay, I see the problem here. Or, oh man, I'm dating a dumb motherfucker. All right, let me kind of help her out with her little show and shit. Some niggas will show the compassion. Some niggas will show the compassion. But others, he gonna kind of go along with you, and that kind of says a lot for your unit. Because the thing is that she may like this for the content. She may even come back and look at it and be like, yeah, he was kind of wrong on that. Oh, well, that's him, and I love him, and well, yep. Sometimes they think like that. And sometimes they're like, damn, I got this type of nigga. Women think like this, man. They hot one day, they cold, man. One day it's chickens, big baby. Next day it's feathers, man.
Good. Then you gotta ask yourself why. Why is that? And if you are attracting people that, you know...
Remember, you may not agree with me today, but you got 365 more. Let's get it.
And if you are attracting these people and you decide to entertain them, that is also your problem, because you shouldn't entertain them if they're no good. You know what I mean? So...
I just want to clear one thing up, because you said, and I know you didn't mean this exactly verbatim, but you said in order to be a proud black man, you have to have, you know, the black woman and black children.
Here we go. Hit the nail in the coffin.
You should at least want, you should want it.
Exactly. That's the only thing I wanted to just
say. Oh, yeah.
Your mind state should at least be traveling in that direction.
As a man, you should have a natural instinct to want to protect and provide for women and children, black women and children.
Really?
And if you don't have that natural instinct, you are profoundly out of tune with your masculine traits. And this movement is making you like that.
That's what
this movement, whether you like it or not, is.
That's what it means. If you're not like that, see the shaming? It's like, really, you couldn't find anything else smarter to say. It's like this movement, and then she has another to say. This movement is making you like that. This movement is making you act this way. Get it together. Grow up. Protect me and the child. That's not yours.
It's for lost men that did not have a father figure growing up, so they need guidance,
really?
And so they're lost, they're confused, they're thinking this movement is going to empower them.
Really?
It's for lost men, it's for immature men, which you can kind of say if you're lost and you don't know, you need guidance, it's a possibility that you might be a little immature when it comes to what you should and shouldn't
do.
You might need to
get on the ball and learn how to protect us and kids. Did I make those kids? No, but you need to protect me because you're not a man and you're not going to get this pussy. You're gay? Are you gay? Fuck out of here, bitch.
You know, getting in tune with your masculine self.
Not her. It's for, like, I'm just saying in general.
Men, lost men, bitter.
All of this is just regular black woman talking points. Not her, but I mean, this is just, never mind, I'm having a flashback.
Men and gay men. And that's exactly what's going to happen.
What?
Like, this is for immature men, which you can kind of say if you're lost and you don't know, you need guidance. It's a possibility that you might be a little immature when it comes to what you should and shouldn't do, you know, and like, you know, getting in tune with your masculine self.
Oh.
It's for like immature men, lost men, bitter men, and gay men.
Oh.
And that's exactly what's going to happen. Like, this is like the
gateway
to homosexuality. And a lot
of men,
in a couple of years, you're going to see a lot of very aggressive.
Really?
Because you can be aggressive, you can be assertive, you can be competitive, you can do all of that.
Uh-huh.
That doesn't mean that you can't be gay. And if you find yourself in a position to where you're going further and further away from children, you're not in the mindset where you even want, I mean, away from women, you're not in the...
Funny thing is... They will talk like this, right? And then when they get around trans, they will like trans dudes. You know, you do know trans dudes listen and hear them saying this, right? And a bit of them are actually offended because they're like, well, even if he is, what's wrong with that? You understand what I'm saying? It's like she talks down and emasculate at the same time. Some of them trans dudes are trans because they grow up hearing this, and then they jump on the other side of the fence, and then they're like, well, I don't want to be like this no more. I really would want to be a guy with a nice woman, but they didn't really go after me, and then I kind of start doing this shit. You know what I'm saying? There's some niggas out there, dog. Hey, look, I don't know shit about that, but that's that motherfucking story. You dig what I'm saying? So what I'm telling you is that when these black women start emasculating y'all niggas, dog, y'all better learn how to identify the shaming tactics. And it come in flavors, too. They are really good at it. It come in flavors, son. They will say some blasphemous shit. But what I'm saying is, I actually talked about how this scenario happens. And watch, them trannies are going to come after them in the future. Like, black women, they... Bro, the type of shit that's going on right now, I mean, and it's not even saying in the future. They doing it right now. Like, right now. They've been doing it. Like, right now. I've seen bitches with holding their babies get hit by trans, bro. I said, damn. And it's going to be to a point that straight niggas really can't do shit about it. They're going to do it. But a trans will sit up here and see you, like, you know what I'm saying? They'll, because they believe either way, nothing's wrong. But they see it. That's why there's a divide. Watch, there's a real divide between that shit. I already told y'all what's going to happen. Actually, I have a clip. I have a clip just talking about that exact same shit, because the evidence of things that I've called in the past, a lot of these roots are bearing fruit, my nigga. A lot of these trees are bearing fruit, my nigga. I just need to go across the certain parts of the farm and pick these berries and show you. I just pick the berry up, I cut it open, and I show it to you. I'm like, look, see, this is the exact shit that I told you. Because I plant this berry over here with this berry tree. So now by the time these berries grow, you know, they're going to be a different color. And I'm going to cut it open. And it's going to be a deeper version of that color. And I'm going to show you the game on how I did it. Because I put these two trees together. See? See how that works? That's what's going to happen. So they sit up here and they're coming, sisters. I'm telling you. I'm only making this long. Because I am about to clip. I am about to copy and paste. I'm about to cut and take this same clip and replay it in the future. And I'm going to be like, see? Here we go.
The mindset where you even want children, you're going to be surrounded by men at some point. And you're going to, you know, like, what are you? You're not going to be protecting what women or children. You're not going to be providing for them. You're not going to be leading them. You're not going to be touching them. So who are you going
to
be around?
Your life path is to do whatever the fuck you want to do. You don't have to spend your whole life and protect women and children. If you want to protect yourself, do that. All right? If you want to, I mean, it'll be nice. All right? That's what it is. It'll be nice. Courtesy, if you do. But you're not obligated to do that. And don't give a fuck about if somebody say if it makes you a real man or not. If that's what you want to do, don't give a fuck if somebody says if that makes you a real man or not. Because 9 times out of 10, the motherfucker that's gonna shame you is gonna be getting killed. They're not even going to be alive long enough to realize if they made a mistake or not. So sometimes you just let these people shame you. They didn't do their homework. They're way off the mark. They're not even talking about MGTOW. This nigga was talking about popes and priests and shit.
You're going to be around a bunch of men. Eventually, you're going to, like he said, have some perverted thoughts, and you're going to end up being gay.
I don't know about you. MGTOW's out here fucking. MGTOW's out here fucking and chucking, son. Gliding and sliding.
That's jail. Let's just put it clear.
It like, is.
Any situation where...
It's jail.
You're going to sign up. You might as well just say, yo, fam, just take me to jail. Because you're basically signing up...
MGTOW is jail
within
now?
The context of saying that you basically don't want to be around women. So if you're going to be around men all day, what? To me that represents jail. That's something that... I've always tried to stay away from to the best of my ability.
Yeah.
I don't dig that energy. I don't dig the energy. Another thing is like, you know, and it goes both ways. It's the same thing for feminism, for the feminists as well as this MGTOW movement. Listen, brothers, look, you can certainly be a masculine man. You can be purpose-filled and driven. You can be a leader. You can be all of those things without bashing or, you know, being bitter towards black women.
Exactly.
People who get their sense of empowerment from bashing other people, that's the bully. You know what I'm saying? That's the bully mentality. But everybody knows you came from where we came from. It usually was the bully that you punch him square in his mouth one good time and he folds. So don't ever, don't put yourself in a position where you know, you feel like you give yourself kudos or you feel bigger because you're saying, oh, it's your fault, it's your fault, it's your fault. But at the end of the day, you're at the center of your own universe. You're the star of your own movie.
That's very beta male-ish, actually.
You know,
when you feel very inadequate.
Oh, that's very beta male-ish. Oh, you got a little bit of game on you, huh? You gamed up, huh? Beta male-ish, huh?
In a sense, yarr, and you see? Feel like you have to overcompensate by being overly aggressive, and so it makes you feel good to try to put other people beneath you because you know that you are already low. So it makes you feel good to disrespect other people and make women feel like they're less powerful than you.
And it's the same thing. Let's be balanced, because it's the same thing with these feminist women, because I've heard everything from men are created just to be our slaves and all of this stuff. So it's like both sides of the coin, man. Yeah. Listen, we were created for each other.
Yeah.
Period. It don't matter. Like, it should not be this game being played of, like, more important on each side, because the reality is that this whole shit stopped if we both not present. You know what I mean? Game over. End of the game. Ain't no empires, no more legacies, no more, you know, us returning back to our glory to where we were building pyramids and mapping out the star constellations. Ain't none of that shit fitting to happen if these two can't get along and make this thing work.
Exactly.
That's not true.
So don't join that side and don't join that side. That's not true. What I mean?
I think there's only one situation where men or males should go their own way, and that is with, like, the rites of passage movement. I know that you are, like, mentoring.
Yeah, indeed.
And, like, that's the only time where men should be, like, away from women.
Well, I mean, where is the thing? So don't
you join that. Tell, look, the only time you should be away from us, oh my God, what?
That side and don't join that side. You know what I mean?
I think there's only one situation where men or males should go their own way, and that is with, like, the rites of passage movement. I know that you are, like, mentoring.
Yeah, indeed.
And, like, that's the only time where men should...
The rites of passage movement is the only time where men...
be, like, away from women.
Well, I mean, here's the thing. I think there's gonna be times where men should go their own way. But see, this is the difference. Like, when you say a rite of passage, right? The difference with a rite of passage is that's a system and a structure built, or ritual, if you want to put it that way, for a man when he's in that teenager, preteen stage to prepare him for manhood.
Yes.
Not when you a 55-year-old bitter man online.
Yeah, and what is manhood? So the whole, you know,
like, manhood is protecting and providing and being a good husband and a good father. Yes, so the whole essence of the rites of passage is to prepare you to be a better husband, to be a better father, to be a better leader, to be a better king.
Yes.
But when I, because we watched the video.
To be a king, to be a yeah. Oh.
You know, not too long ago, one of these mid-cal guys, and he was talking about, you know, it's like a rite of passage. But, yo, bro, you 45 years old. It's not time for you to do no rites of passage. Yes, there are going to be times where I feel like women should have their sister circles and their healing groups.
Absolutely.
It's going to be times for that. Brothers should be out, you know, maybe going to the range, going to the gym together, going fishing, hunting. Yes, we should. If you want to say that's us going our own way.
You ever had somebody that was bad at ad-libs? Yeah.
I mean, maybe, but when you say, like, the way that these guys put it is like saying, you want me to go this way. You know what I mean? Like, the women want us to go this way. No.
Bro, she just told you she just got done telling you the only time you should be away from women, son. Oh, my God.
We're going to go our own way. You know what I mean?
What was funny?
That's not what's happening out here. That's not what's happening. So I it kind of make me reluctant to say.
Some of this energy on camera is fake, though. Yeah, baby, you a little bit over enjoying some mediocre shit. I'm about to get some pushy tonight. I'm bringing joy to my queen.
You know, if brothers want to go fishing, that's going our own way, because I don't want to tie into that whole mindset that they got, where it's like, ooh, women trying to make us do this, but... Nah, fam.
Yeah.
Nah, man. And if you keep running into women that make you or trying to take you in a direction where you should not want to be, that you don't want to go, that's on you. That's your problem. That's you, because you can't in one breath say that you're a leader and we put here to be alpha and dominant and this, that, and the third. But then you keep letting women run you all around the goddamn place. You a problem.
Put it back on the men. Didn't say, niggas don't say nothing about women. Just, all on the men.
Probably just us, a weak man. Let's just be honest.
Yeah, be a
because
man.
Because when you find a good woman, right? When you find a great, when you find a goddess, you find a queen, right? Just be honest.
Hey, son, he got the baritone. When you find a goddess, He got deep into that shit. He said that word with conviction. The nigga said that word with conviction. See, that Hotep, see, Nature Boy be doing the same thing. That Hotep game only works on women. It don't work on real niggas, dog. Real talk, son. I mean, I get where you coming from, and I understand your message and stuff, and I know you, you know what I'm saying? And it's not you. I'm just, I'm only doing this because I'm talking about niggas that just say, I mean, you're one of the type of niggas, I mean, obviously, but I'm not talking about you personally, but nigga. This is that same Hotep game Nature Boy be trying to run. Uh-huh.
Because when you find a good woman, right? When you find a great, when you find a goddess, you find a queen, right?
A goddess.
She's going to enhance your shit, fam. Excuse my language, but we just going to kick it real as brethren. She's going to enhance you. Oh. You're going to enhance your whole life.
Really?
You're going to feel more masculine. You're going to feel more in tune with your purpose.
Really?
You understand? And I would imagine it's going to be the same thing for these feminist women.
Yeah.
Maybe because you keep dealing with bullshit men and women respectively, but that is only a reflection of you. So, again, do the self-work before you keep out here pointing fingers and bashing every goddamn body.
Right.
You need to put a mirror in front of your damn face, point at
just
yourself
like y'all put a mirror in front of MGTOW. Y'all looked at MGTOW, right?
To change certain things about myself so I can attract what I want and what I need.
Yeah.
And fuck all that Peter Pan jail mentality shit, because don't no real man want to be around men all day. I don't care how you feel about it. Call me a simp in the comments if you want to. I'll be a simp any day of the week, but I'll be the simp over here with the other men who enjoy being around strong queens, that enjoy planting seeds in
more
the fertile
shaming.
Earth and popping them seeds out and raising them to be the same way I am, where we don't want to be around men all goddamn day. That's simp shit to me. So you can call me a simp, but I'm going to tell you one thing. I'm going to be a simp over here with my queen and my seeds. I'm going to be out here living like goddamn king.
Building
and you're
going to
be out here living like Peter Pan. Round here with a whole bunch of men in your onesies complaining about what women not doing right.
Yeah, they're bitter. Like, you know, it's bitter.
That's
like, when a man is bitter, he's very emotional.
This is
he
the
gets
wrong
kinda
person
into his feminist
to
even
have
though y'all don't
MGTOW
express it like
it.
Crying and whining. But in the sense, that is kind of like what y'all are doing. Like, when y'all get all y'all feelings and stuff.
Well, they be in the comment section
when
crying.
When women who are bitter, it makes them more masculine. So I understand that y'all have gone through bad relationships. You might have had a bad relationship with your mother. You know, in this feminist movement, I know it's annoying. It annoys me, too. But it's not all women, you know. And the paradigm is shifting. It really is. So y'all really don't need to join a movement. Just say you're single. Just say, hey, I'm single, and I'm just going to focus on being the best me that I can be. You know
right.
what I mean? You don't need to try to prove anything to anyone else. Worry about improving yourself. And that's one thing about the feminist movement and the MGTOW movement. Everybody trying to prove that they are worthy of respect. They're trying to prove that they're masculine and prove that they're the alpha this. And it's like, no, don't try to mean so. Yeah, I'm not a MGTOW advocate. I know some people think I am. I'm definitely not. When I speak about black women, it's not because I'm bashing them. It's because I just want sisters to be accountable for what they do. Because
no,
you can't be powerful until you are accountable for
right.
what you do. You know, that's how you take power back. You know, and I just want women to be in tune with that feminine side. I'm getting tired of the whole masculine, Miss Independent. I don't, you know what I mean? So that's why I talk about it. I don't do it just to bash women. So I know a lot of y'all think that I'm part of this MGTOW red pill. I'm not. I'm not an advocate for it. And honestly, the way I feel about it, if you have that type of mentality, then you don't want children, you don't want a woman, and you're moving in that direction. Either you're immature, you're gay, you're lost, you're bitter. And if that's the case, and I understand some of you are lost, and you can come back from that. You can grow out of it. Hopefully, you can find better guidance.
Wow, you just skip to all of that shit. You never just once thought, you know, maybe you might have been hurt, and you may need a little bit of time to yourself, and maybe you'll come back. But, you know, this is not the way to go. You could have said that. But you're gay, you're bitter. Come on, man. You just insulting these niggas.
But if you're the type of you just like, no woman, no children, I just want to be MGTOW all day, every day. You know, if you're one of those type of brothers,
how can you do
then
that?
Like, we don't really care for you. Like, honestly, we don't want that mentality in our community. We don't want you to have children. We don't want you. Go your own way. And then that way, when you make your transition, when you pass, nobody will care. You won't leave anything behind for anyone.
Damn.
You won't leave a legacy. That mentality won't continue in our community. You'll just go. And the mentality can go with you. We want all of that to go. The same with the feminists. We just want you all to go. Don't reproduce. Don't have any children. We want y'all to go.
I want to say one last thing, man. I agree with that wholeheartedly.
Yeah.
But I'll say this because it made me recall one of the videos I was watching. And let me be clear about something. I certainly felt, because I think there's room for all of this in one, but they talked about how, you know, it's this attack on masculinity in males, and I agree with that.
Oh, it is.
I 100% agree with that. I think men should be developing more masculine characteristics. Mm-hmm. You know, that's an important thing, and I agree with that.
Yeah.
But again, let me be clear, because that was one of the positives I wanted to say, and I don't know if I said
that
in the beginning.
You did.
I'm all for that. I'm all for that. But do not do it. You don't do it, and it will not work by bashing women. No.
Mm-mm.
No. And nor should you just want to just stay away from women altogether, because I don't know what masculine man, fam.
Oh, God.
The pride, you look at nature.
Oh, God.
The masculine, dominant, alpha male species.
If you look at the colloquialisms of the diatribe of a tiger. See, a tiger never, you know, he never thinks feminine.
And every damn species usually is the one that get the queen, my G. And that's the objective.
Oh, my God.
You know,
if
you are a woman,
you're doing it to get the woman.
This nigga is talking that deep spiritual marriage shit. I see you playing, though. Y'all, y'all got it. I like y'all. Look, man. Yo, they doing it, baby. Yo, they doing it. You see this? Come on, baby. Like, all right, I get y'all. Y'all, it's cute now. I wonder how long they've been married. It's cute now. Nigga, give that shit a good another year or two, man. You ain't gonna be able to stand. Like, girl, you ain't even a... Never mind.
Like, yeah. Y'all going against nature, fam.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I ain't got enough to say about y'all motherfuckers, man. Excuse me. I got nothing else to say to you. You caught the jewel. That's what it is. It's all love from Rock Stages for all my brethren and my sister. Take it how you want to take it, man. But listen, man, come on back to the real side, man. Don't go over there. I don't got nothing else to say about it. If you got something else, you rock out, sis. Queen, I just don't got nothing else to say to him.
I don't have anything else to say either.
Y'all got enough.
If that's really what you want to do, then you can just go.
Go ahead on.
Go away. Just go. We don't want that mentality in our community anymore.
All right, man. So, look, they don't want that mentality in their community. So, half of the black men, y'all got to go, man. Let me stop. Let me stop playing, man. Let me stop. Ollie did that because I knew they were off. But look, they're cool, man. Let me stop playing, because for real, sounds like I'm hating and shit like that. And I'm happy for their marriage. I'm not hating. It's just jokes. I'm just downtown fucking around. Shout out to Sarah Leanna or Sarah Lena. I listened to a couple of videos. She's actually smarter than what I gave her credit for in this video. I was just bullshitting and talking shit. That's all I do. Anyway, look, man, it's Player Talk Radio. We are in the building. Look, man, look. Hopefully y'all learned something. We're going to go a little bit more deeper into the game later on tonight's show. We're going to talk about MGTOW. We're going to have MGTOW Darius. We're going to have a little bit of alpha male strategies. We're going to talk about some real shit that is applicable to the dating scene in 2019. Spring is coming, and skin is coming out and shit. So, look, if you're a motherfucking MGTOW, white, black, or whatever, let me tell you something. It's alright, brother. I'm with you. Now let's rock out with our cocks out.
Isn't the right thing to do?
Come on, brother.
Ever change things that
you're now in the mix with the young DJ Cool.
Yeehaw!
Let's get it.
I'm irritated. Yippee-ki-yay. Come on, brother, sing it with me. This square dance. Fleetwood Mac. Another day. Come on, y'all. We can go. They dismissed us, y'all. Come on. Sing it with me now.
Tell me why.
Why?
Everything turned around.
Everything turned around.
Backing up, checking out, so I'm gonna be
All right, let me stop. All right, let me stop playing. All right, y'all, man, that was Player Talk Radio. Let's get it.
You're now in the mix with the young DJ Kuda.
Tonight we gonna be going in.
On the ones and twos.
Let's get it.
On Player Talk Radio.